avocado.com. More flavors than Baskin Robbins, baby.
Bitch, I just know how to flip a train. Met this bitch when I'm trying to get with a friend, and I know that it's toxic. Hey, what if I found a pound a day? Let me get mine, then I'm out the way. I don't got time for the power play. Out of my mind, niggas sound the same. Ay, but I wouldn't stop if I could. Roll up a chop of the wood. Come to the block and it's good.
Going, going, go, I never sleep, yeah. Yeah, I can't make it stop, it's hella deep, yeah. Yeah, gotta make them break you off a piece, yeah. Yeah, I don't rest until I rest in peace, yeah.
I'm not a rich nigga or a big spender, I'm a ditch digger. Leave your body floating in the piss river. Get disfigured, the lick hitter. Sick trigger, sticking out the whip look like an antenna. Keep it a G, I got a key to the streets. They already knew, I thought I was being discreet. Here's a beast, niggas are waiting to see defeat. Here for keeps, I don't do none of that internet beef. Nigga, we just gonna meet, we meet. Then we meet and you don't wanna fight with me. You're all of a sudden not with beef. You see this Glock 19 in my fucking boxer briefs, and now you're fucking copping, please. I took my shirt off and showed my taco meat for nothing. I wanted to fight. That boy right there too restless. That boy right there.
Battle that just got dropped on King of the Dot. Town Business 2. RONE versus CHARRON.
Ooh, gotta turn these over
now. This is the third battle released from this event. Fire ass fucking event. This is Roan's quote unquote return. He took 2 years off. His last battle was against Head Ice for the title. CHARRON's been fucking killing it. He's been doing great. So this battle was
nerd battle.
This battle was definitely like had a lot of hype going into it.
I don't got papers, dummy. What make you think
Wait,
these are papers?
Why does it say 9 people watching? There's definitely more than 9 people.
There's only 9 people here, bro.
No. Why does it say that?
Shower organic. What does that mean?
What the fuck is going on? Why does it say 0 watching now? All right, whatever. Fuck all this. I don't give a shit. But yeah, Rone, CHARRON, great fucking battle. This battle is incredible. Rone has been doing absolutely amazing things for his career over at Barstool. Love Adam so much. I'm like so ecstatic to see him being successful. And then CHARRON also, I'm very, very happy to see him doing so well with Wildin' Out. With his career, I could not wish success on 2 more great people. So, really interested to see how this battle goes. Let's get it.
I'm not been looking forward to for a long time. My name is Organic. You can follow us on Instagram at KOTDTV, and of course my co-host.
Shout out Organic Stunna Shades is wearing inside.
Long time.
Man, looking. Looking
he's stepping his game up, bro.
My name is Organic. You can follow us on Instagram at this one up. Something I've been looking forward to for a long time. My name is Organic. You can follow us on Instagram at KOTDTV.
Why are you
and of course,
that?
My co-host.
Shit. You know I'm holding it down for that hyphy set. And
yes.
You only got your choice of the bitches that I reject.
Oh, shit.
God damn.
Can I get a. Grazie.
Yeah, Correct. Gully TK, follow me on Instagram, Gully TK, KOTD TV, all that shit. Cali, let's make a classic with this one.
To my right, former champion, introduce yourself. Rony Bay the Prince, formerly the King. What's good, Oakley? Let's go! To my left, introduce yourself.
Hey, yo, what up? It's CHARRON. Make some noise, Oakland. Let's get it.
Yo, how it was weird hearing Organic just say, to my left, introduce yourself, because usually he's like, rapper to my left from Ottawa, or like.
Does he? I don't know.
Yeah, but he's just like, rapper
yourself.
To the left.
No.
Introduce yourself.
That's what he always does.
He says, coming from. All the way from, because we're in Oakland, he's from Ottawa.
Rapper to my left, introduce yourself!
Whatever,
I think that's what he does every time.
Introduce yourself!
Yes, fist pounds all around.
CHARRON won the coin toss. He chose to go first.
So loud. Organic is so loud. I just realized how, like, fucking ear-piercing his voice is.
He's a great host for that reason.
I said, welcome home, Rone.
Yeah. Yeah. Fuck, I wanted to roll a blunt.
We got time. Fucking roll your shit.
Roll your shit.
Y'all gotta
spit
wait.
Your shit.
Y'all gotta look at Roan right now, just looking
at
the
we'll do something
down.
Else in the meantime. We'll put on a really funny battle that I watched the other day.
Damn, y'all waiting for me to roll blunt. I love the VIP treatment. You already fucking know y'all going to
I'm going
to
turn this off so you
while
get, guys
don't
can't
roll
see
this. Like, imagine that.
Where I'm going.
A watch just frozen right now. Fucking deal with it.
We're going to watch the beginning of this battle.
What are we doing?
Where is it?
Come on, man.
I was watching this last night and I was fucking dying. Yes. All right.
Oh my
yes!
God, this is
fuck
already
yes!
funny. I don't know what the hell
this shit
is.
Gets me more hyped than
that
anything
intro
in the goddamn
is the
world.
Fucking
it's time to man up. You got something to prove.
Funniest fucking intro I've ever heard in my life.
Fighting for dollar signs, money. Watch if you lose. This is real talk. Leave the bullshit at home. It's not a battle. This a war in the dock for the throne. From the streets to the stage, bring the heat to get paid. No mercy
bring the
for
heat
MCs,
to get paid.
Not bringing the A game. So when you think that you're hot, bring your shit to the spot. Put your money where your mouth is. King of the dot.
Woo, man.
Hey, yo, what up, welcome to the third annual
Juice Dog. Juice.
Oh, Diz, you're in for a real treat. Keep rolling that piff, bro.
Even the king of the dot. That's what it is. So first, it's on him. Right. 1 minute.
Hey. Yo, internal rhymer, you're rhyming internally. Joking me, I'll crack your spine in the surgery for trying to murder me. My rhyme's so hot, they burn in the third degree. The only time your rhymes rise when hot is when you swallow mercury. Woo. He's always lame and he sucks.
What the
this cat is amazingly
fuck?
Fucked.
What the fuck did he just do with his head? Did you see that? He's like,
dude,
I don't know. I think this guy's name is Patman.
Is when you swallow mercury.
Yes.
He's always lame and he sucks. This cat is amazingly fucked. Yeah, he was...
He's amazingly fucked.
This cat is amazingly fucked.
Oh no, we can't
mercury
watch the old King of
he's
the
always
Dodge.
Lame and he
crazy.
Sucks. This cat is amazingly fucked. Yeah, he was making the bucks I heard by shaving the nuts of his...
Yeah. You know, I've always told them, hey, man, why don't you, like, remove shit off your page type of shit?
Because
no,
I...
They want to keep this type of shit up. What?
Yo,
I would destroy this if it was my channel. I would destroy it. I would give this video a virus on purpose.
Yo,
and corrupt the file,
this is
bro.
Proof.
Tell
I watched
the guards,
this
hey,
last
bro.
Night. I'm the most recent comment
who
here in 2020.
Still nobody, bro. You're
that
the
was
only
me.
Person in there. That's what I'm saying. Look,
dude,
bro,
I was
I
laughing so much watching this last night. It was
nah,
fucking
man,
incredible.
You gotta tell these type of dudes, hey, man, the cameraman's fucking camera, something like with the thing, and then corrupted
oh,
the
it
file,
deleted
bro.
It.
The file's deleted, bro. No. We're not watching his opponent, bro. Go back right now. I'm already done with the blunt, bro. It's a wrap.
Is it wrapped?
The fuck is this?
All right. That's my favorite battle of all time, guys. If you want to check it out, it's called Internal versus Patman. All right, we'll just watch the beginning of his opponent's round. It's so
misery into a fucking murder mystery.
Just, please listen to it. Please, it will trust me. It will make your day a lot better.
Yeah, time, just Pat.
Just listen to the beginning of this
bro,
guy's
I'm gonna
verse.
Get really mad, and then I'm gonna call organic.
You're not gonna
get
really mad. It's
yeah.
Very, it's very good.
Gonna...
All right, fine. All right, I don't
well,
pressure
for you,
you.
For you.
No.
For
let's,
you. Go.
Let's watch.
Go.
I already deleted it.
Fucking.
All right.
Yeah, shouts out to Walter Fox.
You got
fuck
your,
yeah.
Your blunt rolled.
Hold on. Hold on. Oh fuck. Fuck.
What happened?
I waited too long and it dried up. It's a Fanto leaf. God damn it.
Can't you just like
fuck!
Lick it again?
No, it broke.
Okay, we're gonna watch the beginning of this.
No! Here, I'll just transport it over to the
no,
leaf
no, no,
right
no.
Now.
Internal versus Patman.
Oh man, come on, bro! I don't want to find out what the internal guy sounds like.
Versus Oatman.
I can't even imagine what he looks like.
Here we go. All right. Yes.
Imagine they're like one of my biggest
Listerine.
Fans.
Listerine. Like, time, just Patman. It's on internal. Right?
Oh
sorry.
Yeah. Oh okay.
Fucking battle.
Three into a fucking murder mystery.
Young
time, just Patman. It's on internal.
Yo,
right?
Fuck your murder mystery. You can't spit like me. I'll make your mouth clean like Listerine. You fucking bitch. You suck dick. You look like Mr. Clean. Is your head bald? Yo, you probably suck dick till you get blue balls. Can't even bust. I'll fuck your bitch up.
Out of here.
Dude, I fucking love it.
Hey, by the way,
you
know what?
Suck dick
you know what? You
get blue balls.
You know what? You
can't even bust.
You just gave me the best idea ever.
What?
We're making this a segment on my show.
We're gonna tear people like this apart.
I mean, yeah, no. I'm gonna destroy, but not today, because I don't got time for them today. But I'm coming back to destroy all of them, bro. These people should have never battled in their life. Bro. I'm gonna fucking hunt them all down and beat the shit out of all of them.
You can't even bust.
You can't even bust. You should be shot.
All right, this is
fucking removed forever.
Even when your Fanta leaf is ready, we're gonna get ready. This.
Clean, is your head bald? Yo, you probably suck dick till you get blue balls. Can't even bust. I'll fuck your bitch up, you fist fucker. Put it in a dumpster, motherfucker. Fuck your life. You ain't nothing compared to me.
These fake ass fucking wannabe fresh coast battlers.
Oh my god. Ah. This made my night last night when I stumbled upon this gem, and especially this guy's horrorcore raps and then Hollahan.
I feel like Matt Ills is responsible for this shit for some reason. I don't know why. Nope. I feel like he has something to do with this.
R3CJ. Thank you, man. Oh my god, I'm dying.
Mad Ills.
Fucking dying.
You look like Mr. Clean. Is your head bald? Yo, you probably suck dick till you get blue balls. Can't even bust. I'll fuck your bitch up, you fist fucker. Put it in a dumpster, motherfucker. Fuck your life. You ain't nothing compared to me. I'll tear you, your pussy menstrual gland. You're bleeding eternally. Plus, you wear some fucking shorts, so you must shave your legs. What the fuck, man? You're.
Plus, you wear shorts, so you must shave your legs.
You wear shorts, so you must shave your legs.
This guy is practical and illogical at the same time.
Gay and dead. I'll break your head. You're a fucking fake fed. You're doing a fucking
horse. Oh my god.
Menstrual cramps. You're bleeding eternally. Plus you wear some fucking shorts, so you must shave your legs. What the fuck, man? You're gay and dead. I'll break your head.
You're gay in bed. I'll break your head.
You're a fucking fake fed.
You're a fucking fake fed.
Y'all some weirdos. Fuck.
What are you talking about? This is eternal.
You're doing a fucking course of police foundations. 20 goons around here will pound your fucking face in. Motherfucking cop blocker. I'm a mic blocker. You a Harry Potter twatter lookalike. You'll probably kick you in your face in. You can't see my vocals or bifocals. You're gonna die local. Little bitch, go back to Guelph. You're like a fucking geeker elf. So fuck.
Drop him off a fucking cliff.
Oh my god.
Toss him off a fucking cliff.
Oh my god. What are you talking about? This is. Dude, let's see internal versus twerk in 2020. I'll fund it.
Internal versus twerk?
I'll sell something. I have nothing left. I'll sell this camera.
He said internal versus twerk.
Yes.
That just sounds like the most fucked up shit
oh
ever.
Oh my god.
If you ever did went to the point where you did something that ridiculous, how funny, like if we actually trolled twerk, hit him up like, hey man, so we just gonna give you a good look here in Cali. We got a check for you.
Yo.
We just want you to kill a random fucking no name. He won't know nothing about him. He'll show up and we'll all know it's the funniest shit in the world, but Twerk won't know who he's battling.
Low key though, if Twerk wrapped his first versus Charlie Clips, which is probably my favorite round ever, against this guy's first, it would be my favorite battle of all time.
Well, I just
it would have everything that's great about battle rap. It would have the best parts about battle rap from an artistic and creative standpoint, and then the best parts about bad battle rap, which are equally as entertaining to me. So,
that is so funny.
You ready?
Yep.
Got your shit rolled? All right, let's get it. Whew, baby.
Home run! Hey! I said, welcome home, run! Feels like king of the. Hey!
You probably didn't miss anything.
I said,
no,
I welcome home, Rome!
Yeah.
Feels like king of the dot to me. Corey, Adam, let's give the whites what they want to see. I said two crumbs. Tex will hit you. Someone get Joseph Kahn to make this set official. This time, someone get Joseph Kahn to make this set official. This time you're getting bodied, Adam. This revenge for pistols. Cans up. Let's do cheers. So many shots, he thinks it's New Year's. Get iced so hard, he'll quit battling for 2 years. Like a sore loser. The fans just wait around. Since 2017, bitch, you haven't made a sound. People are out here, but no, they can't just wait around. Man, this is welcome.
It's all good, let him. He just stumbled a little bit.
Quit out like a sore loser. The fans just wait around since 2017. Bitch, you haven't made a sound. People are out here, but no, they can't just wait around. Man, this is welcome to your retirement, Holmes. I'm Grandma's favorite now. I put
crazy. Crazy. That
he
was
said
dope.
Gramus. I'm Gramus' favorite.
That's just his steez.
Wait, so go back again? What's the lead up to Grandma's favorite?
Since 2017, bitch, you haven't made a sound. People are out here, but no, they can't just wait around. Man, this is welcome to your retirement, Holmes. I'm Grandma's favorite now. I put that on. I put that on Agnes and Bertha. I put that on Agnes and Bertha. They heard I'm invincible. Every grandma's giving me this round. Werther's Originals. Right now, his grandma's like, Roan, stop it, dear. Your birthday card'll get no guap this year. It's getting quiet for your Grammy. Soulcon's career. I've been wrapped in plastic like the couch in your grandma's basement. Your whole family's racist. I've killed so many smack rappers, I'm your grandpa's favorite. Fucking MGK, KK, nah, that's an angle I can't try. He reversed racism, I can't lie, cause he dressed up as Lincoln and got his chain taken by a black guy. This that white on white crime. You are the biggest cokehead in all of grind time. If that was the truth, Holohan, switch to my side. Fuck. Again? I'm just playing this man's lucky. The only person to come from behind Rome, Sandusky. You ask Danik for more money. Gave him all kinds of quotes. He flew me first class. He made you ride the coach. He's like.
That is fire. That's his first fire boss.
Is there a double meaning that I'm missing the point?
Yes.
Kinds of quotes.
Listen.
He flew me first class. He made you ride the coach. He's like,
how did you not catch that?
Oh, yeah, that's good.
That's like a really creative way of saying.
That was dope.
I think the only person to come from behind him is Sandusky. That's extremely like weird.
But he was roping it into Holohan.
Yeah, and that all that was not good. It was not good. But I think the ride the coach shit is very creative.
Yeah,
like,
where
the quotes. He flew me first class. He made you ride the coach. He's like.
So you took him a minute to catch it.
Yeah. As did I.
He's like, bro, that's a piece of cake. That's the cheapest angle he can take. Well, if you don't like rape jokes, then stop being raped. He's like.
A little insensitive, Charron.
It's cool. It's a good
bar. Soulcon pops out. I'll save you.
He's like.
Quit being oppressed, Charron.
You gotta know, I got a graphic mind. You can't be saying stupid shit like this. I just imagined him.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh my God, Roan.
Whisk
Roan
away
for you.
He's like, be more creative next time. My name wasn't in the headline. He never gave me red wine before bedtime. You're from Philly. It wasn't Sandusky, it was Tech 9. You blew back.
I don't react to Tech 9.
You blew Pat in a Cadillac. Why was it filmed for? His throat's still sore. We saw Adam choking the caddy. Happy Gilmore. It was Tech 9. His throat's still sore. We saw Adam choking the caddy. Happy Gilmore. In a crack. Hey.
It just hit Jay.
Hey,
perfect
timing.
Look what he does here.
Hey, you blew Pat in a Cadillac. Why was it filmed for? His throat's still sore. We saw Adam choking the caddy. Happy Gilmore.
Yeah, thanks for reenacting.
In a press conference, you told Head Ice, I sucked your dick straight like that, and guess what, Wolf? It tastes like Pat. Rome fans, we need to see you. Rome fans, we need to see you. Y'all need to hold this L. GBTQ. I mean, you gave head to head and blew Pat's day too? That's gay, dude. We're all waiting for you to come out. Like your smack debut. I mean,
wait, did he get his shit shelved?
Yeah, he battled. He supposedly bodied Danger Zone.
And they never put it out?
Yeah, the audio is really bad, so it's like they didn't put it out for that reason.
No, it's a good bar then.
It's a shame. It's a shame, man.
Hey, you gave head to head in Blue Pat's Day 2? That's gay, dude. We're all waiting for you to come out. Like your smack debut. I mean, used to be the man, now you background. Represent Philly worse than the smack crowd. Do your virgin jokes, they'll react loud. You think I've never touched a pussy? Well, I have now.
Drone is so smart when he battles, man. He knows the shit that the crowd would just fucking
eat. Yeah. No.
He's that's a smart battle rapper.
That's good. You know what that is? That's just good performance right there. He's performing good. He's stepping up his performance.
Yeah. Hey, do your sports references real slow. This is a 3-0 field goal. Flip shit. I'm mad at with the hit stick. Fucking up his return. This is a squib kick. You need Paul Bears? I'll pick six. Pistols with that big shit. Secret. Johnny Manziel. First.
You don't think this is believable? What are you laughing about, Diz? He's got guns. He's got the pistols.
it's just so funny watching him get so.
He's like, aggressive. I'll pull the cigs out.
Oh my god, like, I'm
with
sorry.
Fucking up his return. This is a squib kick. You need Paul Bears? I'll pick six. Pistols with that big shit. Secret. Johnny Manziel. First round bust on this rich kid. Go play pistols. He don't listen to the same whistle. Get laced out and turn bitch. Ray Finkel. This guy ain't a motherfucking MC. I know everything he's about to say against me. I am autistic. I do rap about guns. I did sell furnaces door to door like a scum and have a dumb friend named Hunter. 100 bullets that got me slapped over a cap gun. I did it by the 100 bullets that got me.
Blaming that shit on bullets? Like,
let it go, let it go, man. Just let it go.
This guy ain't a motherfucking MC. I know everything he's about to say against me. I am autistic. I do rap about guns. I did sell furnaces door to door like a scum, and if a dumb friend named 100 bullets that got me slapped over a cap gun, I did get jumped. K-Shine's still a chump. He shot.
That is funny, R3CJ. That is hilarious. He said, Rumnity said that squib kick line against Surf exactly the same. But whatever.
He got jumped?
K-Shine's still a chump!
I did sell
furnaces door to door like a scum, and if a dumb friend named 100 bullets that got me slapped over a cap gun, I did get jumped. K-Shine's still a chump. He shot.
Carl, appreciate
Damn,
you,
that's
my
crazy,
man.
That's crazy, Carl. It's that's what's up.
Seek.
Shoddy Horror did fuck my girl. I've still killed every smack rapper in the whole fucking world. I told the URL I have a small dick. I say it proudly. I act gangster and I said that.
Yo, I was dying when he said that.
Let me spark this again, bro.
When he said that, I was fucking dying.
Like, here's the thing. There's a paradox here. And do we give him points for making fun of himself? And
I mean, the way he's trying to do it, it's working. It's like the 8 Mile thing.
It's really not. Just because it's working there doesn't mean it's working. It's really not working. And I guarantee you I'm not the only person saying this.
Yeah,
like,
for sure.
I see where he's going with it. I'm trying to ask you, at one point in battle rap, like, it depends who you are, don't get me wrong. Like, I feel like Uno Lavos and Carter Deems and the guys who are more religiously about comedy.
Yeah.
Could get away with probably doing stuff like that, right? They're very true to the comedic form of just comedy.
Mm-hmm.
Someone like Charrón, who raps about being tough, who gets in people's faces, who gets crazy, says personals to people, at one point does it become acceptable for him to hop back and forth with this paradox of personalities where you're not doing the cheddar cheese thing where we could accept you if you're like Little G or one of these guys that like, cool, I'm just gonna, you know, talk about myself, make fun of myself. Like, Little G says gay shit all the time, but it's all good. Like, it's not gay, but it would be considered gay. He raps about his dick the whole time. But it's okay for him to get away with it because that's the personality he assigned himself to. I'm saying it's the same as a religious dude catching flack, like a Christian rapper, for using guns. At what point are we going to be like, all right, bro, are you really like a shooter or are you a little fucking nerd with a small dick? Shut the fuck up. Like, at one point, or are you like this personal attacker, or do you get to just fucking self-deprecate and you're out of it? I don't think that taking the heat off you like that is the correct way to do it. I think there should be a way around it that requires a lot of substance rather than just be like, okay, I did get slapped. Yes, you got slapped. Part of being a fucking battle rapper in the first place is not getting slapped. Like, that's one of the main things of being a battle rapper. At least, I don't know. Like, those are things that are going to be used against you, and you need to find a different way around them. You can't just be like, oh, just take an Eminem scheme and it's cool. And you know what I'm saying? Like, and then just, I don't know what he's talking about when he said he got jumped and all that. So I'm going to deduct points for all that shit. So that whole scheme is all fucking trash. All right, so let's start from the beginning.
Wait, it's not done. His round isn't done yet.
Was it at the end?
No.
Rapper in the whole really? Fucking world. Yeah. I told the URL I have
feels
a small
like a 20
dick.
Minute round.
I say it proudly. I act gangster and I said that in the battle. I won't say it again.
I love Sharon. I won't say it again.
The angle about it. I never told.
Yo, me, I was, the whole time I was like dying looking at Ron. That's where he was looking. Also, in your battle with Solcon, do you remember you like kept rapping to me in caustic?
Yeah, I do remember that.
It's because we're right there. And
yeah,
I'm,
I know.
I'm assuming
you,
as a performer, it's hard because like you're like, oh, you're right there.
You start spotting people you know and you want to talk to them. It's
yeah.
Cool.
Well, I have a small dick. I won't say it proudly. I act gangster and wear suits wrong.
This shit is gay. Right, Big K? Thank you. Reinforcements have arrived.
Fuck y'all if you doubt me. I'm about to sell your grandma a furnace. I don't want to win. I'm outie. I'm 8 miles ahead of you. Tell him something they don't know about me. Motherfucker.
Great fucking round.
I'm
probably
8 miles ahead of you and outie.
All right. It definitely has a lot of good shit. There's a lot of like meat in the middle of it. You know what I'm saying? Like it. All right. So. His shit iced for 2 years.
Yeah.
Was a good punchline, but the lead up to it was a little lackluster with the take shots like New Year's. And again, it's him just writing shit to write shit. You know what I'm saying? So I'm going to call him out on that. The Gramus favorite now, he actually fucked up that whole beginning. He fucked up that. The meaning, he was meant to say something else as the setup. So because of that, that line didn't hit fully, even if they reacted to it, because it's a grandma's favorite and it's Ron's thing. So then he went off the grandma thing after that, because obviously that's going to work against them. But the initial attack, that 4-bar setup of grandma's favorite now, broke off on the third bar. So when he got to the third bar, it broke. So once he got to the fourth bar, it didn't have that support. It really didn't mean anything what he was saying. He really didn't have a real point of why she's his favorite. Then he had a good bar where you could tell he has that influence where he's using the everything is a round. I'll give you a round like an ashtray. I'll give you a round like this, round like that. He had the round, the Withers original shit.
Mm-hmm.
Stupid little candies, which is a very, stupid little, you know, candies. It's I love the idea, the concept that he's, and it's maybe because he's really smart, that he realized that those candies are predominantly, like, it's something in the old people world, so it could be used as an old joke. He just used it stupid.
Mm-hmm.
He used it with somebody else's metaphor and just threw it in there. Like, I'll give you a round like a pizza. Like, it's just... All right. So then, quiet for your Grammy like SoulCon. That's cool. That was cool. It was kind of hit. Yeah, the grandma favorite thing. The KKK thing didn't hit for me. and then chain taken by a black guy. I see his concept. It's just really cringeworthy how it came out. He didn't deliver it right. Like, just the whole reverse racism thing is already with the chain. That concept has already been used, so he kind of rehashed that concept. I don't know who used that concept before, but it's been
used. So, like, a common theme I'm seeing from your perspective is a lot of unoriginal ideas.
Yeah, I'm just breaking down everything. Like, I told everybody that this is what I'm going to do, and I did it to Thesaurus and Cheddar Cheese, so the same is going to happen with both these guys. So then comes to the famous topic that Roan is associated with, is the Sandusky situation.
Yeah, yeah.
I think with all the Sandusky shit that's been said to him, it's a topic you have to be careful when you enter with someone like Roan, because if it's not extremely original, it's not going to really hit like that once it hits online. And yeah, it might there, and he did get reaction for the Sandusky shit there, but once it gets online, people are going to look over it. They're not really going to give them points for that. You know, it's because they've already heard all of it, so it has to be way better. You could still reuse concepts. You just have to constantly re-innovate. You know what I mean? So the Ride the Coach thing was his moment right there, where he did that. That's where he started to, you know what I'm saying, come with, like, creative concepts that nobody's thought of before. Nobody's told Roan, you ride the coach. Yeah. That's an excellent, original 10 out of 10 fucking bar. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
As you can see, I'm able to spot those type of bars immediately. I'm not going to look over them. The stop being raped, also using the stop getting, you know what I mean? Like that.
Yeah, yeah.
He's using a used template, but in that scenario, the humor in it makes it still an original concept, even though, you know, you don't like this, then stop being this. Like, it's a common saying. Everybody says it. You know what I'm saying? But he did it in a very good way. So I also give him, like, a 9 out of 10 for that or whatever. You know what I'm saying? So then the Tech N9ne jokes. I don't give points for Tech N9ne bars. They're shock value, and especially if somebody's from Philly, like, all right, cool. So we kind of might know this is coming. You know what I mean? The way he delivered it and the way he put it into context was really good, but it's still a Tech N9ne bar, and I'm not gonna even remark on that. I don't rock with it, but I'm not gonna deduct anything for him, because I mean, I should, because he's pandering. Anybody doing it at this point is just trying to get a reaction. Lazy writing. If you don't agree with me, that's fine.
Yeah.
LGBTQ bar, excellent bar. Not that crazy. It's a good bar. The smack debut of Personal. That was really fucking good. And then, I can't even fucking read what I wrote over here. Then he went into, like, the Billy Pistol shit and all that. I want to talk about the Billy Pistol shit. And I'm going to tell Charron just like I tell A-Ward. You know what I'm saying? I think he's using the Billy Pistols thing as an excuse to use gun bars. So he, like, turns into Billy Pistols. Now I can get away with it. Like, no, Charron, you fucking idiot. You're still doing gun bars, and you're still Charron. So, like, it's cool. I can rock with how you're entertaining the crowd, and you're being a good performer. I give you props for that. But you're still going out of your element, and you're not doing what we came there to see, which is fucking rip Roan apart. We don't want to hear how you would shoot him. I'm trying to hear personals about Roan. Real shit about him. Yeah, not shit like, you left us. Like, real shit. You know what I'm saying? It's a good round, but it's a real beatable round.
Cody, thank you, man.
Give him, like, a fucking 6.8 over 10 or some shit. 7. 6.9. 6.9. You got it, Takashi.
All right, cool. All right, let's get it. Top of the first round. Roan.
Gramus.
Round one, it's on Roan. Let's go.
Because I'll shoot you in your fucking face, faggot.
My first battle was in 2009. Shit is truly a disgrace. I've been battle rapping for 10 years. Someone shoot me in the face. What am I doing with my life?
Deduct point.
I'm fucking fat now. Plus my comebacks versus Charron, I'm doing bad. Wow. I mean, wasn't I supposed to make a runoff rap? TV shows, movies, dumb contracts, stand-up, radio, number one podcast, sold-out concert. Wait, I done all that. See, I don't do it for the fame like my enemy does. I put a bone through your cheek like an elephant tusk. And I don't do it, bro. I put a bone through your cheek like an elephant tusk. And I don't do it for the cash, bitch. My cheddar been up. Ho, I'm just doing this for the adrenaline rush. So what's up? I know you've been watching me walk on a sack for 10 years like Vladdy Divac. On the sack for 10 years like Vlad. Two call outs, three call outs. I said, fuck it, he's unstable. But four call outs, five call outs. I'm getting up from the lunch table. But first, a history lesson. Your name was Triple C until you ever heard of me. And then you changed it to Charron 2 months after I hit the scene. And while that all might seem above board, Travis, imagine a battle rapper came out named Chuck Organic. Oh, yeah. it would probably bother you, but I always show buddy love. Just clumped him in with the rest. Never let push come to shoves. I never let push come to shoves, but somehow you turned into this little brother to me, who'd always want to compete, who'd always tug at my sleeve, the bother, the little toddler, the fly buzzing at me, the food stuck in my teeth, the tag under my teeth, the terrible combination of awkward and cocky, chronically sloppy, sonically offbeat. Every single day you should curse God for your body. Your cringeworthy demeanor has this tailored for the perfect takedown. But the secondhand awkwardness of sharing the stage with you made me want to turn the plate down. We watched you grow up from a boy. You have a pervert's face now, and any character assassination will be a nervous breakdown. Yo, your eyes moving, how he's quivering, like it's puberty that crippled him. He's a wet noodle, a drenched poodle, a drooping piece of licorice. From your shoulders to your arms, how you move them like an idiot. If we were judging off body language, bro, you would be illiterate.
This is fucking insane, dude. This is like absolutely crazy.
So we don't, you know, get the
if we're
crying,
judging you off
so
body
we don't
language.
Get the crying Charron fans and the disaster haters in here. I'm gonna start off by deducting a heavy point right off the top. I'm
wearing
battling
purple.
Nope. Okay. For saying I've been battling for 10 years.
So much should be in the face. To
yes.
Enter.
Yes. I'll shoot you in the face if you want. No, I'm just playing. All right. So I just don't think that means anything. So I'm really judging shit for what it means again. So that doesn't mean anything. It's just a funny self-deprecation line he started off with. It's fine. Then he starts bragging about all his accomplishments. Now, notice how I'm using the word bragging.
Yeah.
It's bragging rights. There's a difference between being a bragger and having bragging rights. He came in and introduced himself as the new Charron, the podcasts, all the things.
Ron.
And did it in the new Ron. I mean, sorry. Yeah, sorry for disrespecting you like that. But he's talking about all the things that he did personally that he made happen. But he did it in a creative way. He bragged his ass off and put a punchline to it. I fucking love it. Some shit I would do. then I'm gonna take another fucking point from him. Trust me, we're gonna get to the good part. I'm gonna take another point from him for the bone through your cheek like an elephant tusk. That line has been used before.
Okay.
I'm sorry, Avo. I have the it's back here. The file is here. I think it's a Big K bar. I think Big K has something very similar to that.
Okay.
It might be somebody else, too. So, the source said the bar sucks. Oh, no, he said that bar is fire. Never mind. The dude above him said it sucks. Whatever. So, here's the point. Whether it sucks or not, I'm deducting a bar because it's not original. Then he started cooking because he ended with the adrenaline rush. And up until he said adrenaline rush, Roan was still shaking off the two-year rust.
Mm.
It rhymes almost with it. He was getting rid of the rust. By the time he got to the adrenaline rush,
He's ready to bust.
He was just getting rid of the rust. So what he was doing there was just building up. Then he started with the Vlade Divac, the sack line. You know what I'm saying?
But that's a personal and a metaphor, because it's not just he's talking about Vlade Divac. He's saying, you're on my dick and you're annoying as fuck. So then he went into the lunch table shit. You hear me? And then he went into like the whole shit about him. He did the buddy love shit, the Chow Organic. He started building the case how this fool is like in his shadow. And then he started the whole thing about tugging at his sleeve, and he's like the annoying thing stuck in it. Now let me tell you something. A fucking man. RYD is breaking his character down to a T. It's actually exposing the inner workings of how Charron thinks he gets his battles or where he should be. Like, he always comes up to somebody and violates them until they agree. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And like, that's always been his thing, because no one wants to battle him. So he's always, and I'm not gonna say I don't want to battle him, I just got no comment on it. I don't feel like battling him. So then the buddy love shit. Then we said the tug at the sleeve shit, and then he hit it with the illiterate shit. So
nuts.
So once he started with the Vlade Divac thing, that's where the point of no return is starting. Like, and at this point, this is why I tell, like, Charron, like, even if I didn't know him, regardless of what anybody thinks, I'll tell him the same thing I just said about Cheddar. You wasted your time talking about hypotheticals and just other shit that doesn't really mean anything. Like, you're targeting some personals, but like your grandma's favorite, and you're taking these slogans and these things that are cool. Like, it's cool, but this person is coming for your character.
Yeah,
he's talking about how you really are to people, and that's what's gonna get people to be like, oh, he's winning right now. That's how you win a battle, is totally. When you start really talking to a fucking person.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? And they have to adopt that. Which is even worse, because if he starts rapping like that, it's not even him. Yeah. A lot of these guys, all they do is learn from us, but then they steal the shit for their own shit, and they get props for it, and then they come back and try to battle you. It's how they always build their shit. You gotta learn this shit. This is how you fucking battle rap. What he's doing right now, he's coming in with a knife for his neck.
Yeah, he's fucking precision and character assassination.
The Sandusky shit ain't gonna piss Ron off. It's not gonna mean anything.
Yeah.
It'll be a nervous breakdown. Yo, your eyes moving, how he's quivering, like it's puberty that crippled him. He's a wet noodle, a drenched poodle, a drooping piece of licorice. From your shoulders to your arms, how you move them like an idiot. If we were the judging off body language, bro, you would be illiterate. Bro,
the setup. Perfect setup. Talking about his arms. No, he's getting to the.
But his karate action arms, that's
yo,
his true.
Yo, fucking Lush, this is so
I heard him. Brody, it is.
But his karate action arms, that's his true talent. Throw him some melons while he's rapping, he'll make a fruit salad. But I'm not here to make an impression of you. I'm here to make an impression on you, to prove that none of your family matter. Don't your uncle nor auntie matter. I'm unstable. I'm Billy Idol minus the Stratocaster. I'll put a foreigner through the rafters. I'm the coroner for these rappers. It's a champ versus a stepping stool. I'm the former, you're the latter. Bro, yo.
That's so
you
good.
Always want-
All that shit was crazy. Auntie
like, because a stepping stool
Joseph,
and a ladder.
Thank you, man. Yeah.
Like, he's comparing it, like, but he's talking about the ladder.
Yep.
Like,
yep.
That's, so, hold on.
And the antimatter bar was fucking
crazy. It was really good. what? I wrote it. That's what I was
saying. Because really
I already wrote it down.
Okay, okay.
Look, it says antimatter
dismissing
right here.
Dismissing me, Diz?
It says antimatter. Okay. Look.
Right.
You, I'm here to make an impression on you to prove that none of your family matter. Don't your uncle nor auntie matter. I'm unstable. I'm Billy Idol minus the Stratocaster. I'll put a foreigner through the rafters. I'm the coroner for these rappers. It's a champ versus a stepping stool. I'm the former, you're the latter. Bro, yo, you always wanted my chains. Well, today we could fulfill that. You never have to win a title. I'll leave you permanently still, champ. See, I am offended at any list where your name is ranked ahead of me. I am resentful of anyone that puts you in the same breath as me. The only chance you'd ever be ranked ahead of me is alphabetically, so thank the letter C. This gonna be
so
agony, like you were acting stemony.
Good!
Yeah, he's killing it.
So
fucking good. The only chance you'll ever be ranked ahead of me is alphabetically.
So thank the letter C.
That's good too, but like I'm already at, look, I'm all about the setups, man. Like he might think that that's the punchline. That's fine. I already knew that that's what it was.
Yeah.
That's the whole point.
Yeah.
Is that the punchline is really the
yeah
ranked ahead of me alphabetically. So perfect, so precise, flawless airtight, multisyllabic. You know what I mean? Pattern right there.
Yep, he's killing it.
Word of mouth. At any list where your name is ranked ahead of me. I am resentful of anyone that puts you in the same breath as me.
The only
chance you'd ever be ranked ahead of me is alphabetically, so thank the letter C. This gonna be agony, like you are at Gethsemane. You should be banned indefinitely like Randy Gregory. I'm here to get under your skin like an appendectomy or Patrick Beverly. Yo, I'm here to get under your skin like an appendectomy or Patrick Beverly. Bro, you have the personality of a patch of celery. You should have been in the band in pregnancy. You misunderstood your girl's Tinder bio.
I'm not fucking around. Oh no, just you guys tell me.
Who's Patrick Bellamy? He's a basketball player.
Beverly.
Letter C. This is going to be agony, like you are at Gethsemane. You should be banned indefinitely like Randy Gregory. I'm here to get under your skin like an appendectomy or Patrick Beverly. Yo, I'm here to get under your skin like an appendectomy or Patrick Beverly. Bro, you have the personality of a patch of celery. You should have been in a band in pregnancy. You misunderstood your girl's Tinder bio when she said she wanted to be challenged mentally.
Amazing. Pause. Well, hey, what we have over here is he went from the antimatter shit, you know, and the only part he had in here that you could even critique is the still champ shit. I'll leave you permanently still champ. Just cut that out next time, Ron. That was just the, you know what I mean? It's just so much harmony going on. That part was unnecessary.
Mm.
Like, the whole antimatter, the former you latter, then going into the resentful, same breath as me, alphabetically, Patrick Beverly. Like, he had, like, patch of celery, and he kept on going. And, like, telling somebody he has the personality of a patch of celery, as forced as it sounds,
it's amazing.
It is incredible.
It is amazing.
Because you're just, that's it. Like, yeah.
Boring.
Yeah, fuck you. Yeah. You're a carrot, you're a corn cob. Like, it don't even matter, really. Yeah. Like, I'm going with that. And he ends it off with an extreme personal, and a personal that the person he's saying it to, like, look, I always look at these things really deep. It's his strength. He's not only making fun of him for a personal, he's making fun of him for a personal that he uses in battles to his advantage. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So he's fucking him up.
Yeah, for real. For real.
Shut the fuck up!
He's been chasing me for so long.
Fuck
it's
Ryan.
It's really got me in a whirlwind. It's got me wondering, who's really your white whale? Me or your little girlfriend? I mean, he thinks that whore's a looker because she looked like some sort of hooker. It's no wonder that he get jerseyed as soon as Cory Booker. But you came a long way from Laura Tarsi. We look back and still laugh. You used to have a fake girlfriend. Now your new one is real fat. But your jokes stolen, concepts stolen, wordplay stolen, and he thinks all of it's fine. He can't go one battle without repurposing someone else's good idea. Shit, probably mine. So for your round.
So that's really good. Saying what you were saying about Sharon's whole round. That statement.
Oh yeah, he's about to get into that.
Yeah.
But I definitely feel like. See, like, this is what's happening with Rone. Maybe he's still trying to test the waters coming back because he has these really, really flawless attacks. And then he goes into some, like, Cory Booker, da 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 da. And then he goes, and, like, the real fat, your girlfriend is real fat.
Yeah,
like,
that could have demanded.
That's very bad. Like, yeah, for Rone, that's very bad. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? We can't overlook that because then I would be over here.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But so hold on. Far. Then he jumps back into what you're saying. Look, he goes from that. Like, he could have just attached this to the challenge mentally and just keep on fucking him up, like, personally.
Yep.
Concepts stolen. Wordplay stolen. And he thinks all of it's fine. He can't go one battle without repurposing someone else's good idea. Shit, probably mine. So for your raps about selling drugs to the bars that Corey's stealing, I might have to take a hand off since he act like Corey Dillon. But you said I turned my back on battle rap. We need to stop the cap. You're acting I robbed the culture with a gun and a stocking mask.
Stop
I've had battle rappers.
This is what I mean. I made fun of his. In the beginning, it might have taken his hate when I said you have to say more than just you left us. Mm-hmm. Remember how I said that in the beginning? Because that's not a good fucking angle for Rone. Sure enough, Rone has the perfect answer for it. Because it's not a good angle, or Rone would have had no answer for it.
Yeah.
He's still in, I might have to take a hand off since he act like Corey Dillon.
Here we go.
But
look, he answers.
But you said
it,
I turned my back on battle rap. We need to stop the cap. You're acting like I robbed the culture with a gun and a stocking mask. I've had battle rappers on my phone suicidal. I'm the one that they called the chat. It wasn't the king of the dot Facebook group. I'm the one talking back. I see a battle rapper down.
He's a good
I see
friend
a battle
too.
Rapper
I'm
down.
A point.
No problem. I offer cash. I had them eating off my plate when you wouldn't offer scraps. GoFundMe's tickets, pay-per-views. No problem. I'm dropping racks. I'll put my money where my mouth is. What's more king of the dot than that?
This round is fucking nuts. This is such a crazy round.
It's not our fault. That's why I wanted to watch.
You could never match my moves either in or out the ring. They call me Rony Bay the Prince, but to you, I'll always be the king.
Hey, you know what's so funny? Charron has that same, like, no look that he had on his face when Pat was telling him I'll always be the king and all that shit.
Oh,
he's like, no.
Oh,
that's
such
an easy
a good
one.
Round.
There's
such
so much shit
round.
In here. He has, so he has like four or five misses in there, right? But it's a long, healthy round with a lot of material in it. I'd chalk up his misses to rust and just getting back into groove. It's a different crowd. He hasn't been around this crowd in a while. Like, he's just, I don't think he would have these necessarily if he battled again, or maybe less of them. He doesn't know what they're gonna react to. He might have thought that if he just went super personal and just all character assassination, that people were gonna shut it out and that they want those, like, you could almost see that, like, Rone simplified his writing on purpose in some parts, because he's just like, fuck it, if I go too crazy they're not gonna react. But it's wrong that people are so bored of hearing the same shit over and over that if you have some like really gut-wrenching shit, people are gonna fuck with it. I think
very true.
Most of his shit is this material though, and I think that's why he's getting such a good feedback.
Yeah,
because 85% of his material probably is shit like this, you know, from what I remember. Like, I don't really, I gotta see it again right now. But.
Yeah. The Rone got the first round. It's top of the second.
Charron.
Grab you, it's our Charron. Let's go.
Yeah, 1-0.
Hey. Hey, man. He always telling me how my hands are out of place. Philly losing back to Mac. This is Meek Mill when he's battling Drake. He said, I'm making a fruit salad. But you dressed in purple. Put the strap in his face. Man, I have this fruit on the wall. Alexander the Great.
That's crazy. Nope.
And you keep doing a lot of gay jokes. Man, I don't know why y'all playing.
Start it again.
Said my girlfriend.
Wait, what was the first thing he said? You said, I keep moving my arms like this.
This is Meek Mill versus Drake. Because he's from Philly? And Drake is from Toronto. Get it?
All right, well, listen. I'm not giving him a point. Hold on. I'm not giving him a point for that. I'm not giving him a point for his also setup. I'll put the strap in his face. I'm not going to give him that. And Alexander the Grape is an observational punchline on the wall. It's no different than anybody's.
It's cool.
It's cool.
Was cool enough.
No.
You keep doing a lot of gay jokes. Man, I don't know why y'all playing. You said my girlfriend is fat. How many times have I told you we're not dating? I mean, bro.
First of all, Ron isn't fat. I don't know why. I don't know even why he called himself fat. He's like, not fat. Thank you.
You're speaking for me.
Stop body shaming Adam. What the hell?
No, this is a very bad robot.
SoulCon pops out. Stop body shaming him.
Ah, you're body shaming my friends.
Is being fat so wrong?
I'd vote for a fat person.
Hey, listen. That's not good. You're Charron. You're one of the best freestylers ever. You just told Roan, me and you are not dating, and then it's already a stupid fucking line.
Yeah.
And you're telling him he's a fat dude when he's, you know, nobody watching this is ever going to look at you two guys other than two skinny white guys. Like, I don't know why you see him as this. I don't know what made you say the line because you're a fast thinker. But you know you've been talking a lot of shit, so I'm gonna definitely call you out on anything stupid you fucking do, like this.
Hey!
Yeah, like, what are you talking about?
Hey! So Organic hit his phone up.
Mm-hmm.
For 2 years he didn't show up. I'm not surprised he split. That's what atoms do when they blow up.
Fire.
But I'm not out here exposing you. You already done that. I'm not mad you moved on from battling. That's what you're supposed to do. I'm mad that once you made it, you didn't put on anyone that's close to you. See, I helped Carter with Wildin' Out. We trained a lot. I told Ward, come here if you want to take my spot.
All right, hold on. All right, Sharon. You're going into a shaky, very murky waters here. I like that you're responding. That you're responding to his response. You're like, you're basically saying, I didn't say you turned your back on battle rap, which is really good. You're being their stimulus right there. But then what did he say after that? You remember what he said after that?
He didn't put anybody on close to you.
He said, you didn't put anybody on that's close to you, and for Ronan, what he's doing, like, who's gonna have, like, fucking, you know, like, fucking thesaurus on Barstool? Like, what is he gonna do? Like, get one of us to, like, put us on how? Like, Ronan's doing his thing. And then he goes on to brag about he put on Carter. So I'm just asking you this, Sharon, why you're in murky waters. You better be the person that put in the call for Carter and really got him on the show, and that's cool. You helped out one of your homies. Maybe they was looking for an extra funny guy, but I think they wanted Carter. I don't think that you're the reason Carter's on Wildin' Out, but I could be wrong. I just feel like right now you're going into a weird angle, and it better be strong, because it's looking shaky.
All right.
That fool made it. You didn't put on anyone that's close to you. See, I helped Carter with Wildin' Out. We trained a lot. I told Ward, come here if you want to take my spot. If I had your platform, do you know how many names I'd drop? Once you get a bar stool, you're supposed to start taking shots. I mean,
No, because again, all right. His point was bar stools and shots. But he's telling him once you have a bar stool, you're supposed to start taking shots. So, like, what do you mean taking shots? Are you helping people or are you taking, like, what do you mean taking shots? You mean calling shots? Like, again, the structure of it, like, he's relating the word shots and bar stools, but what do you mean you're supposed to start taking shots? And then saying, I told A Ward, come here if you want to take my spot. So you invited A Ward to get murked by you on Wildin' Out, and you think you're helping him? Like, I'm trying to figure out the weight of this convo, this argument that you're posing to him. You're bringing, this is what battle rap is, it's a debate. You're bringing your side of the story or your piece that you want to speak, and there has to be structure and reinforcement to what you're saying. And right now, that went nowhere.
Yeah, I guess I could see that.
That went nowhere.
A real king would have came back to start raising his stock. You're an NFL blogger. You should know when you drop the ball, the game doesn't stop. You are not one of us. Who is on your number one podcast? Not one of us. Doesn't matter. Stock, you're an NFL blogger. You should know when you drop the ball, the game doesn't stop. You are not one of us. Who is on your number one podcast? Not one of us. Doesn't matter if you're GZ, I'm still supporting you. Go to war with you. You want me? Because MTV could do more for you. The Midget and Joker, you need a killer to open up doors for you. I have more money and still do this for fun. You're from Philly. You should know where your roots started from. Got a bone to pick with him. Look what you'll become. On God, I'll make a bitch out of Adam. Genesis 2:21.
Shout out to A Ward.
What's Genesis 2? Is that a basketball player?
You're an idiot. I can't believe I was going to explain that.
You got to look at me when I'm killing you, bro.
Hold on, though. An interesting observation that I think a lot of people have missed from From my accurate analysis of this here going on, I've seen that a lot of people missed that Rone just got done telling him, you take other people's ideas and you fucking rehash them.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And he just did a not one of us. And he just took Averb's shit and rehashed it. So,
yeah,
there's a little bit of excellence on Rone's part for where he's writing in the past, because he's dissing Charron for his past. He's dissing him in the present, and he's setting up roadblocks for him in the future.
Yeah.
This is a real strategy that's going on here, whether he intended it or not. Like, Charron's starting to fall into it.
Yeah.
I don't know. What is that, a vacuum or something?
It's the camera. Oh. I'll make sure it doesn't do that.
Just keep talking.
So, yeah, I know you guys agree with me, because this is a very accurate breakdown from a... I'm basically, like, know what I'm talking about. I'm like a human computer when it comes to these type of things.
Shit, you're a computer?
I'm a computer.
Dude.
Computer talking to a computer. All right. So, wait, hold on. And the not one of us thing went into the MTV, and I could do more for you. And that was really good. He was doing a setup. But he went more for you, opened up the doors for you again. That was really good. But the structure's okay. The roots started from, he's starting to have good punchlines about his case. So he wanted to build this case against Rowan that he doesn't know where he's from. And that he's fucking, he looks back on, like, he's just abandoned everybody.
Mm-hmm.
I think the best line he had about that was, you're from Philly, you should know where your roots started from. And that this is
messed.
That's good, but, like, everything else he's doing is, you know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah, yeah. No. Nah. All right.
The bitch out of Adam. Genesis 2:21. To go. Hey, hey. Hey, you gotta look at me when I'm killing you, bro. You gotta look
verse.
At me.
I didn't read that verse.
Hey, 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 hey. To go viral, you.
Rona, I didn't read that verse.
To go viral, you change your gender like Caitlyn Jenner. You have no shame whatsoever. We've outgrown you. Adam's bitch made from the rib cage. We want the old you. Dude, his pussy so bad. If you were T.I.'s kid, he'd disown you. He's like. Hey, hey, he's like, yo, he's like, I'm American as shit. I'm Honest Abe mixed with John McCain. Well, I'm battle rap as shit. I'm body bag mixed with shoddy swave. The near divorce caustic maid. Tom Cruise mom shoes. We don't walk the same. Tom Cruise mom shoes. We don't walk the same. I'm a lush intro with his nostrils glazed. I'm Hey, Tom Cruise, mom shoes, we don't walk the same. I'm a lush intro with his nostrils glazed. I'm the energy of I'm the energy of disaster, but not the braids. I'm three of them. Hey, hey, hey.
This guy got a fucking.
Not the braids.
This guy got a fucking 10-year-old fucking gay little boy sailor haircut, and he's talking shit about me.
Hey, hey.
That was a good bar, though. That was a good bar. That was a good bar. Like, His way of putting it together caught me slipping right there, you know what I mean? But fuck you, you have weak ass hair, you know what I'm saying? You ain't fucking with my shit.
The braids, I'm three of them things. Off the brain, I'm Pat Stay when he got the chain. I'm the apology you forgot to make to Cadillac Ron when you dropped his name. I'm PH,
damn,
I'm PH in his team homie ways. I'm every bender multi schemed on a stage. I'm king of the dot in their beatboxing days, mixed with the six people that lost their life getting crushed by T-Top on stage. And in this battle,
but like,
somebody said, rest in peace.
No, that's a really good bar, but like, he said he's the six people. I'm the six people that fell.
Yeah, that's super funny. Like, what,
I'm the
what
six people
mean?
That lost their life on stage.
Yeah. Yeah. And the resurrection.
I love Charron, man.
I'm the six people that died. And in this battle, battle, he started off with battling for a decade, you're truly a disgrace. If I'm battling in 2021, someone shoot me in the face. You've
good.
Used battle rap since day one. This is where we both got our fame from. If I'm battling in 2029, pat me on the back like thanks for remembering where you came from. Oh! Hey, 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 hey.
See, like, if Charron had substance like that throughout all his attacks, he would really decimate Rowan. He would.
Like, because that right there, as a response to what he just did, already just, like, is all the fucking whack shit that Charron did leading up to this, he, like, made up for a lot of it. Because that, what he just did, is really hard to do. Because he normally freestyles some bullshit like he did in the beginning of this round. Fuck it, what did he say again?
Alexander the Great.
But before that, his fucking weird-ass setup to it, I forgot.
Meek Mill and Drake.
Yeah, like, back to back! This is the shit. Like, this, doing this to Rone puts him at a huge disadvantage. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
This is an extreme haymaker. Probably the biggest one of the battle.
You got a nice flow, but no punching skill. 10 years, I'm punching still. The Philly Prince will get sunned in Cali. I'm Uncle Phil. Slash throat. They put a face on a shirt. R.I.P. the frat goat. This time when you go viral on a T, it ain't for fat jokes. You handpick.
Definitely heating up.
You handpick opportunities. It's see-through. Gannick didn't even say your name. I knew it'd be you. I just said, I think I'll win, and he wrote hashtag me too. I'm your executioner, Lucifer. Shut the fuck up. Your time is fading. Rone, who are you annihilating? You look like all five people that died from vaping. You call it a... calling out Mike P? Dog, that's light. Bring him to the smack killer. We're not alike. I'll treat him like the show you got fired from and drop the mic. I got a violent left. Antifa, you getting floored this time. Fuck a metaphor, rhyme the right. We'll have him higher than our credit scores combined.
When Charron, like, does really good setups, he could rest assured that I'm going to catch them. You know what I'm saying? Like, if he does whack shit, I'm gonna call it out. Like, the left, the violent left, like Antifa for the setup for the right, like the credit score, is my example of how he should rap all the time. Mm-hmm. That's what we bust our ass doing. The fuck you get a pass for to just come with half the shit. So, like, this right here is really fucking good.
Yeah.
This is, like, really good.
He's killing it.
And well, the died from vaping shit has a lot of Fresh Coast influence in it, so I give it a...
Antifa, you getting floored this time. Fuck a metaphor, rhyme the right. We'll have them higher than our credit scores combined. While you were doing keg stands, grabbing your friend's erection, I beat you in a freestyle battle with less aggression. Listen, Rome, this ain't beer pong. You won't get redemption. The frat killer. Tell Brad, Thad, and Chad, this verse is amazing. You can't fuck with the GOAT. This ain't fraternity hazing. How many IPAs have you tried today?
Amazing.
Your parents?
Charron, seven.
Amazing. How many IPAs have you tried today? Your parents got the job done. My sweet 16, not fun. What you know about asking your dad for two Mercedes, and you got one. This ain't for the new fans that just want us to hold lead. Code Red, Conor McGregor. This for the old heads. Rone, you ain't nothing but a fucking cokehead. Waiting for someone to have a bump for him like an old thread. I got all kinds of tablets I could supply this attic. So much speed, Al Davis tried to draft it. Have him snore until he feels ill. Coke so white, Method Man assumed it voted for real deal. He gonna make this Barstool versus Wildin' Out, and that's a fact. I mean, I don't even care, and you claiming I don't clap a gat, bring up Timothy Delaghetto, because he's got the man purse, it just means my man is strapped, but who from Barstool is here to support you? I mean, that guy's whack. I mean, hey, man.
I loved when Charron said that, because that guy was from Barstool, and he goes, fuck you.
Yeah, that's
he's like actually mad that Charron called him whack.
Well, that guy's whack. I mean, Hey, man, they not. Hey, they. See, hey, your friends aren't in your corner, and that's a fact. This is no matter how much you ignore us, you will always be welcome in battle rap. One day you'll be fired from your job, and that's a fact. But don't be surprised, because a bar stool never has your back. Time to go.
Dope ender on that.
Back. Where
Rone's
do we stop
defense
off?
Is fire. I love Rone's defense. Mm-hmm. He's like, how many IPAs have you tried today? And he's like, seven.
What an idiot. Awesome. All right, so the fraternity hazing shit that he did.
Mm-hmm.
Because we're going after all the stuff I already said. The IPA line to bump the thread. The real deal line was really original. I like it because people always come with the this so white that this and that. So, like, the so white thing, he latched on to a more recent topic that people will understand, and it won't be worldwide, it's just for the fans. It's a really good round. It's a very good round.
Yeah,
like,
very
it's
good round.
Way better than his first round.
Yeah, it was awesome. Fuck yeah!
Round two, it's on Rome, let's go! This shit's a classic.
Or Gannick's excited.
Yeah, Gannick's hyped.
Imagine being a grown man Charron fan.
Leave me alone, nigga.
I won't. Your taste is terrible.
He got
you
that
Ilmac
Thesaurus cyber
yeah.
rebuttal.
Yeah,
shit
which is great.
Leave me alone, nigga. Your taste is
terrible. Plus one for bodying his fan
your taste
too.
Taste is terrible. You talk about bodied like it's Rocky. The delusion is astounding. Its budget was $15 million,
right,
and
wrong.
It grossed $100,000.
Also wrong.
And you have what?
So I'm going to have to correct him on that. I'm sorry, Ron. I don't mean to call you out. It definitely was like a couple million.
Yeah, it wasn't 15. But
and it grossed
hey,
way more than $100,000.
He's using it for his narrative.
Yeah, no, that's cool.
It's
but
working.
You got to get the facts straight because he's putting out extremely false facts right here. For and if I call Charron out for it, don't think I'm not gonna call Rone out for it. Like
hypothetically, he said. He said hypothetically.
Did he?
No, I'm kidding.
You fucking liar.
It's astounding. Its budget
funny,
was $15 million, and it grossed $100,000. And you have what? Two more lines than me? Shit ain't never been funny. Congratulations. You had a bigger part in losing Eminem's money. But while we were shooting bodied, you were drinking in the lobby of the Standard in Los Angeles and you were getting sloppy. You started mouthing off to Pat Stay. I thought this won't go well.
Uh-oh.
And sure enough, he bitch slapped you in front of the whole hotel.
What?
And I don't want to misconstrue it. You got-
Wait, this happened? Come on, confirm.
I don't know.
How
no
is nobody, I think it did. Has it? Because you know what the thing is about Pat, man? Like, I feel like Pat will slap the shit out of a hamster if it disrespects him. Like, I feel like Pat will look at you once or twice
but
and be like, oh,
his
your
size.
Smile.
That's what you're saying. No, I'm kidding.
He doesn't give a fuck about
I'm
it.
Joking.
I feel like he's
I'm
one
kidding.
Of those dudes that will step on you even if you're tiny. Like, Pat will do that to you. Like, he doesn't give a fuck.
Word.
Been off to Pat Stay. I thought this won't go well. And sure enough, he bitch slapped you in front of the whole hotel.
That's a fake person.
And I don't
want to
misconstrue it. You got slapped and your lip was drooling. You would have thought that he dropped this fruit from the way that this bitch was bruising. That's why we laugh when you talk tough. Like, who does he think he's fooling? You almost died off that smack in the LA hotel. We would have thought he was Whitney Houston. I mean... You were a terrible drunk, and he smacked you in the Standard. So K-Shine's not an outlier. Smacking you's the Standard.
That's
I mean,
another
hey, I mean,
that's
a
why
Bird
it might have happened. He just built a case. See, this is what Ron is doing. So if he's lying or he doesn't know if it's true or if it's a rumor, he just brought up
painting
a case.
The narrative. All,
yeah,
all
where he
matters.
Got smacked somewhere else yeah. though. So like at this point, he's just saying it happened twice.
Smacked you in the Standard. So K-Shine's not an outlier, smacking you's the Standard. I mean, A-Verb stepped to you, shotgun peppered you, Bonnie almost broke her fucking wrist dick checking you, Shine made... I said A-verb step you, shotgun peppered you, Bonnie almost broke her fucking wrist, dick checking you, Shy made a mess of you, Pat disrespected you, Arse had his hands on your face like he was blessing you. So who the fuck are you playing with? Who the fuck are you playing with? You already been 86th. I don't mean they canceled you, I mean number of hands on you if they dusted your face for prints. I mean...
Wow.
Why does that always happen to you? Why does that never happen to me? It's not happenstance that they slap you, fam. That's just who you happen to be. But you embrace this school shooter image like you think that shit's powerful. You embrace a school shooter image like you think that shit's powerful. Till I lift you up and beat the fucking warning signs out of you. This one's a can.
Again, bro, Ron is going straight for his character, bro. You see what he's doing?
Yeah, this whole battle is super character assassination.
Like, because, look.
I mean, Sharon's second was...
This was the point I was making in the beginning. He could self-deprecate. See, people didn't understand. I wasn't hating. How long are you going to accept the self-deprecation? Like, I got smacked. Someone is going to talk to you like this. Like, that doesn't work for you to be like, yeah, I got smacked. So what? Like, you can't do that. Like, you can't... Because he's going to come in and list all the times you got smacked. Arsenal fucking mushed him in the face and did all that shit to him. Bonnie fucking... That was the funniest shit that he said because he even threw Bonnie in there. Which was so... So he's like assassinating his character and then he's hitting him with the dust your face for Prince. And then he's telling him like, bro, this is who you are. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, and then he's telling him like about the school shooter shit. How he, like, always says, I'm like a school shooter. And he's telling him, I'll beat the warning signs out of you. That is so good.
Crazy. It's crazy.
Warning signs out of you. This one's a camcorder. It'll help deliver the picture. This one's a transformer. It'll turn him into a sprinter. Your dad's a mechanic from Orleans? Well, I had to have a talk with him. It's funny, he works at Midas, and you got a touch of autism. But you take pride. Your friends are laughing at you. You take pride in wilding out. When it's legitimately terrible. 15 straight years of the same Mariah Carey joke. Oh, word to Nick Cannon's turf.
That is fucking amazing.
Years of the same Mariah Carey joke. Word to Nick Cannon's turban. I've been offered wilding out 6 times. There's written record of that. 6 times. Ain't that the amount of seasons that you've been in the cast? From Wildin'
and
Out.
And this another thing, like...
From Wild...
We don't know... Like, he's killing his character off, but we don't know how real what he's saying is, but what if nobody knows, and it probably is true, like, what if Rone is just on to something? Like, you know what I'm saying? He's telling him, like, ain't that the same amount of times you... Maybe it's not proven, but what if it never gets proved? Because obviously you can't prove it. But what if, like, Ron really on to something? What if it's actually what Ron is saying? Fuck that.
What if?
What if? It's personal. You gotta know if they're real or not, man. I don't know.
Yeah. That. 6 times. Ain't that the amount of seasons that you've been in the cast? From Wildin' Out? From Wildin' Out to drop the mic to battles in this league. They'll only ever call you when they can't book me. The name brand versus the budget version, the undeserving, less funny person, the first choice that they cater to versus the backup, the safety school, the option that's less sexy when they can't sign Gretzky, the Chrysler 300 they rent when they can't afford the Bentley.
So fucking good.
And all of Viacom loves me. They would kill to write a check. They would kill to write a check. They'd have a pilot waiting on me like a fucking private jet. Yo, you sound like you're high on helium. Your show is the height of tedium. This skinny little geek's trying to make it on TV. That's a dying medium. But before I retire his ass like Andrew Luck, let's talk about that time Organic watched some groupie bitch and you fuck.
This is 100% real.
Just watch this. Organic's like talking to somebody else, and as soon as Ron says Organic, he's like,
watch. It's a dying medium. But before I retire his ass like Andrew Luck, let's talk about that time Organic watched some groupie bitch and you.
He's like,
he just froze. He's like a deer in headlights, dog. Amazing. And Andrew Luck.
Andrew Luck.
Such a shame.
Let's talk about that time Organic watched some groupie bitch and you fuck.
Oh, God.
You went soft. You went soft.
Organic is like...
Nah, he lying.
Fuck.
Yeah.
Trust
you
me.
Went soft. Yeah. You went soft, but tried to keep going because the audience had you rattled. Isn't it bad enough he has to watch you pretend to be hard in your battles? Bro, you love...
That is all personal. Now, whether... oh, my... Whether that was... The other shit was real or not, that was a personal that really fucking applied.
And he made it a funny personal, and I don't know, man. He's fucking him up, dog.
You love to go on smack to brag on the fake crack you slang and gats you bang. If it were up to you, you'd be on a band every month like Andrew Yang. But what about that time when you said Mexicans can't be superheroes because, quote, they're too lazy, bro? But what's really lazy, though? The accent? The basic quotes? The fact you were hitting a Dominican with racist tropes that aren't even creative jokes? I mean, Corey Sharon hates the Mexicans more than the Border Patrol. He's not calling shots. He's calling cops to a foreigner's home. He'll cock his gun. He hears someone say, Senor, on the phone. Well, the coroner's home. Put four in his dome. Get beat to death to leave the flesh around your cornea swole. This a orchestra. What you pen is boring and slow. Past your expiration date. Baby, wait, your formula's old. You going the wrong way at every single fork in the road. I'll leave your body stretched out like the warrior pose. Out of all the battle rap, I got the corniest clone. You hate Mexicans? Then get the fuck out California, bro. Bro.
California.
Bro. California, bro.
Bro. Bro. He's not done yet, Diz.
All right, keep going.
Fuck Drew.
Bro, I'm a mix of Rambo and Tone Soprano. I'll tag your man's toe like I was Virgil Abloh. You're off white, thinking you got the best answer. And you'll have something you want to get off your chest after, like breast cancer, because at the negotiating table, you're softer than Ned Flanders. You're not scoring Travis Scott Jordans. Your check's backwards. Bro, I got a million ways to kill him. But if none of all that work, I'll just drop him off in East Oakland in his Confederate flag shirt. Bro, you could never match my moves, either in or out the ring. They call me Roni Bae the Prince, but to you, I'll always be the king.
I'm shocked you didn't go in on that topic more.
I think somebody else already did, that's why.
Some devastating shit in here. He went from the warning signs to touching on his autism, no pun intended. The autism touch line. To making fun of the Wild and Out shit with the Mariah Carey joke line, which is like so, it's extremely creative because it's almost something everybody's thinking, but nobody's said it. Like, we've heard that so many times, but nobody says that. Like, bro, like, we're not trying to hear bars about Mariah Carey, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And like, so like, that's incredible. Also, what did he have after that? He had the six-time thing. So he started building a case that, like, bro, they really wanted me. You're like the backup dude. And then he went into the fucking Gretzky fucking Bentley comparison, which to the average viewer might just be a punchline, but let's keep observations at a high level. Charron wanted this battle to be, we are both the same person. He started it with, like, me and you are like the whites and we're microphone yo-yo. So he was, like, playing. He was. So Rone having the answer for that.
Yeah.
Kind of solidifies that, like, Rone is not talking about some far-fetched shit. He's not doing it for the scheme. He's letting him know, bro, I'm not like you.
Mm-hmm.
Like, stop making this, like... So then it goes from that to the, he had a good bar with the pilot waiting on me like a private jet, which is like cool. He's showing rapping ability. Then he went into, again,
wasted zero time with that. Charron did a lot of that. He wasted zero time. He had the private jet line and then pretty much went into the, oh, how about the time like when they watched you fuck and all that. Yeah. So then he started spitting like personal shit about him. Then he went into another line like Andrew Yang, a band every month, which is cool. He's rapping again. Then he had the Mexicans, his lazy approach.
Get out of California.
How do you judge an approach like that? Do you consider it do you think it's a smart approach since he's using the territory,
yeah,
let's say territory, not crowd, smart, against Charron, yeah, or is it pandering? Smart. You don't think it's pandering?
It is pandering, for sure, but it's smart pandering.
But you look at it more in a positive light, depending on how it's
that
executed?
That I'm kind of dismissive of, because I think he targeted a line that was so minuscule that nobody even really remembered it. I mean, I'm trying to even struggle who he said it against. I'm assuming it's Storm, because Storm is Dominican. So it's like, that's such an old battle that I'm like, we don't really remember him saying that, you know? So.
Horrible stereotype, by the way. Mexicans literally work harder than everybody.
For real.
Shit started
for real.
I think it's just like out of state
ever.
People or some shit.
White people being horrible.
I don't even know where that came from. It makes zero sense. The Senor on the phone scheme was not his best shit. I feel like he was just filling up time right there, but he got his point across already, especially when he started up there with the Bonnie shit all the way down. I expected him to go in more on the Confederate flagship, but you said it's already been used, so maybe that's a good answer for
it. So who would you edge the round to, I think?
Ron still took the round.
So 2-0?
Yeah, because, again, Charron does not make me feel something's wrong with Ron. When the round's over, I'm not getting this thing that Ron is like affected, or I'm looking at him different. But every time Ron goes an extra 4 bars, he's warping your perception of Charron.
Yeah.
This is why he's winning the battle.
Yeah. Word. I mean, I wouldn't disagree with any of that. I think the second you could probably argue that Charron took, but I think that Ron
he did a little bit better, but
second. Not a bad round by Charron by any means.
Where
both
was it again?
Both are crazy. This battle's fucking really impressive.
No, the problem is, Charron had a blow up like Adams.
Mm-hmm.
A really good bar, stuff like that.
Yeah.
But what's the point he's even getting at? Again, it's back to that same angle. You left us.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, Ron is not wasting time to talk about shit that's not going to affect people. I could say that to SoulCon because he's been gone for a decade.
Mm-hmm.
The guy that just took like a year or two break, like, what are you doing?
Yeah, it's like, it's hard to call that a break.
Like, what are you doing? Some people go like 3 years before they battle. Like,
for real.
So, yeah, I don't know. But I give Charron something. The rebuttal to I remember where I came from was extremely powerful.
Yeah.
Like, it
lined up good.
Like, if he kept. That's the whole thing, is that if he kept having that type of answer to what he was actually saying rather than, like, trying to get us to convince us to believe that he's this fucked up person that doesn't care about us, rather answer things, attack them right away, like, how he did with that, how he flipped his whole thing. That's crazy. He had the whole thing already, like, he wrote it.
Yeah, it lined up perfectly.
You know what I'm saying? Like, that is the way he needed to combat what Ron is doing right now.
Mm-hmm.
It's 2-0. I can't. I'm sorry. I can't look at it any different.
All right. Top of the third on Charron. Let's get it.
Round 3. It's on Charron.
No. These guys are funny as hell. Mm-hmm. Round 3. Oh yeah.
Hey. Hold it down. Final round. Let's go.
Damn white boys can speak though.
He calling me racist, but they say. Head ice robbed you. Your third round was light. If you couldn't make it out of Harlem, how did my dad make it out of Harlem? Because he's white? Like, was that a third round or a third Reich? I mean, I'm no B-Dot.
I'm not an expert on this situation. And this is coming from someone that accused BT of discrimination. But between your dad... But between your dad and Head Ice, who struggled in life more? You said it's not your fault if you're born poor, but it is if you die poor. That's what your physicist dad taught you? Well, he set up your trust fund? Due to his skin, which Harlem cops did he run from? Which neighborhoods? Which schools was he shunned from? That mentality is the same reason that Trump won. You say...
You think this is a good approach for Ron?
I mean, I like it.
Like, but you just heard what Ron got done telling him. How is this a fucking angle right now? This is crazy that... I just feel like maybe Sharon, like, miscalculated with what Ron was going to say to him. Maybe he thought he was going to be like he was against Big T. And he was just going to be fat like,
you're nerdy.
Just making fun
of skinny.
Him. Maybe he thought that. Ron is not playing with him, bro. Like, that... I'm like, struggling to give him anything. I don't know, like, the discrimination thing, the BET thing. Like, I guess that's, like... a cool thing to say, I guess. I mean, if Ron said that, but I mean, whatever. I mean, BET's racist as fuck. This is a fucking channel that didn't even cover the Million Man March. You suck my dick, the whole fucking enterprise. So, anyways, Sharon is not coming with a strong enough case to what Ron is doing, and he's a freestyler, an improviser, and a fluid rapper.
Yeah.
He can easily switch up his whole shit. I'm struggling to understand why he keeps going left away from what Ron is telling him.
Mm-hmm.
Continue.
And my dad was racist about the Mexicans, but come on, son.
Oh, okay.
It's not your fault if you're born to a racist, but it is if you become one. Yeah. Also, against Head Ice, he also said, you're tethered to an existence that doesn't mean shit to me. While I was taking trips to Sicily, you were in self-imposed poverty, figuring out which kid to feed. Cringe, the epitome. You act black, now look inwardly. Predatory lending, they couldn't get help yet. They were designated to hoods, they couldn't get out yet. This motherfucker thought redlining was a Microsoft spell check. Only people on 4chan like how you rap. Your favorite chore is laundry day, so you could separate the whites from the blacks. You spit those bars in Toronto in front of a bunch of crackers. I dare you to come to Cali and say all lives fucking matter. You know how many Trump supporters are here? One. Disaster. And you're right.
Wait, what did he say about you?
He said I'm a Trump supporter.
Toronto in front of a bunch of crackers. I dare you to come to Cali and say all lives fucking matter. You know how many Trump supporters are here? One. Disaster. And you're right.
Shit, all he gets a reaction. That's cool. Mm-hmm. It's a good barter.
You
want
to clear the air of that right now?
No, I don't need to clear shit. I don't care. Hey,
I did wear the Confederate flag sleeve.
That's the reality. You could accuse me for some shit.
Confederate flag sleeve. He called it a flag sleeve.
Hey, I did wear the Confederate flag sleeve.
Like, imagine saying that and being like, all right, guys, I did that, and you know what? We're good. Have a nice day, man. You know what I'm saying? Like, just imagine what world you live in. Like,
a sleeve, though? It was a sweater.
It's a shirt. I don't know. He's just trying to rhyme it, bro. It's Sharon rhyming, bro. He probably needs to rhyme with sleeve. Like, he's probably about to say queeve or something.
Hey, yo. I accept all the scrutiny, acted foolishly, apologized to the, I didn't know the history and apologized to the community. We move as a unit. Why? Because of unity. Yesterday I was called out for appropriation. Today you won't hear an oops from me.
We move like a unit because of unity.
Hear an oops from me. This ain't even a battle. This is a eulogy. That's why I'm Ron, because when I look at you, it's a moment of silence for who I used to be. You brag about your vacays, like look at my big trips. You make 100K. You think MTV's how I get rich? Airbnb, HVAC, that's the right business. You get Bud Light, I sip Chris, knock over his bar stool. You ain't wilding out like this, bitch. Last year, 700K. Those are my digits. You'd have to save up 7 years pay to get my interest. Two apps, get paid when the site gets hits. Inspire kids with autism, plus my girl has nice big tits. Hey, bring it back.
Big titty bar.
Hey, listen. You'd have to save
like
7 years pay to get my interest. Two apps. Get paid when the site gets hits. Inspire kids with autism plus my girl has nice big tits. Listen, Ron ain't the one to talk that I'm winning at life shit with. You tried to stunt on Head Ice. Dog, relax. Bring up my autism. I have retarded stacks. If I wake up.
I have retarded stacks.
Hey.
That's a good punchline because he's telling the truth.
On head ice. Dog, relax. Bring up my autism. I have retarded stats. If I wake up feeling like $1 million, the market crashed. A millionaire at 25. How could the prince be proud? After this quick beatdown, you could battle my pockets and spit your big T rounds. I don't watch Barstool. I put that on the Bible. I'd rather swallow crack before my Morgan's piano recital.
I'd rather
You guys want to look that up before I could go straight?
I don't watch Barstool.
Well, let me hear what he said.
On the Bible, Morgan's piano recital. I'd rather swallow crack before my Morgan's piano recital.
I don't know what the fuck that is. I can't judge him on it. How am I going to know if it's a good bar or not?
Danny Myers did a Morgan's piano. Do you remember? You're not on social media, so you wouldn't know. It's something Danny posted.
I'm on social media.
Not on Facebook, though.
Oh, no, I'm definitely not on Facebook.
So Danny posted like this Morgan's piano thing, I guess, that everybody was kind of like roasting.
This is playing into what I'm telling you, bro. Like, why is he using obscure shit? Like, even the whole thing, like, I mean, he answered back a lot of things that he's been accused of, but he's not even doing it right. Like, if he feels like his explanation for wearing the Confederate flag sleeve, his explanation was good enough, it's really not. That he didn't
really... good enough for me. No, I'm kidding.
He didn't really say anything, bro. Like, he just kind of went into that.
Yeah, he brushed it off.
He's like, we move like a unit because of unity. Really? Is that what happened there? Because, like, I could swear you just, like, culturally appropriated the shit out of the whole entire country, but hey! So, anyways...
I liked his big T, let's battle between our pockets, you can use your big T around.
He started cooking up over here. I like how he ended it with the my girl has big tits shit, because he just kind of self-deprecated and it sounded funny. It was kind of cool. It had a rhythm to it.
He's still
the retarded
He's
stack,
still heating up, though.
The retarded stack shit is good only because he has money.
Yeah.
If he would have rebutted that and he's just another one of these battlers saying they have retarded stacks, I would have gave him a zero for that point. But then he had the market crash bar. The big T round shit was good. Yeah.
Put that on the Bible. I'd rather swallow crap
Super
before my
writer.
Morgan's piano recital.
Super lazy. Too fun, shorty. You're right.
I'd rather swallow one, crack before my Morgan's You're piano right. recital. Or watch another Chilla Trevor know. Rematch for the title. You got a thesaurus for gambling, but bet on sports games all the time. So I made up my own odds on the ways that you die. A trillion to one, you and your fans. A trillion to one, you die from your fans getting trampled in the streets. 1,000 to 1, you OD after your motherfucking panics increase.
Hold on, I'm gonna actually structure each one on paper right now to show you what it looks like. So, the first odds were his fans get trampled in the street.
He dies from his fans trampling him.
Oh, trampling him in the street, doesn't matter. So, then he says, you're panicking, you die because your panic increased. Alright, so... All right, wait, let's hear it. Let me make sure I'm not
die
wrong.
A trillion to one, you and your fans. A trillion to one, you die from your fans getting trampled in the streets.
Okay.
1,000 to 1, you OD after your motherfucking panics increase.
You OD after your panic
your motherfucking
increase.
Panics increase.
So his panic increases
your motherfucking
and he OD.
Panics increase.
He after your panic, and this is horrible writing, and this is
I'm
why
motherfucking
I'm here.
Stacking the
I'll
beats.
Never in my life write shit like this. All right, keep going.
To one, you develop AIDS from Sandusky's beef, or but bet on sports.
This is not bad writing. This is not bad writing.
He developed AIDS from Sandusky's beef.
He has beef with Sandusky now? Or is he saying what I think he's saying?
Is,
he's saying
he's
what
saying,
we think he's
yeah,
saying?
Yeah.
Oh, no, we're from not doing beef. That today.
Yo, from his beef,
Minus. Hold on.
Nah,
Sandusky's beef. Shut up.
You're fucking hating this.
Shut up.
Corona's cooking.
Yeah, I'll throw this laptop
See
in
you,
the
Corey.
Fucking wall. Sandusky's beef.
Fuck out of here.
All right.
Fine. So I made up my own odds on the ways that you die. 1,000,000,000,000 to 1, you and your fans. 1,000,000,000,000 to 1, you die from your fans getting trampled in the streets. 1,000,000,000 to 1, you OD after your motherfucking panties increase. 10,000,000 to 1, you develop AIDS from Sandusky's beef. 10,000,000 to 1, you develop AIDS from Sandusky's beef. 1,000,000 to 1, you die of shame after admitting you got raped once this battle's released. This is karma for all your rounds. I mean, you're not big T fat, but you've put on some pounds. Uh-huh. You quit battling for a podcast. Again. You're basically awkwards now. Uh-huh. You only hit up Gannick when he's got something to offer. You look like a bird and you flock like a vulture. Your dad's a physicist and he named you Adam because you make up everything that's wrong with this culture. So fuck your mother, fuck your brother. I hope your stepmom dies. Fuck every Ben Shapiro speech on your desktop drive. Fuck barstool segments on the best pop flies. You make podcasts for white kids to drop the N-bomb on Xbox Live. Fuck you for not knowing what your privilege does. Fuck the Barstool founder for calling all women sluts. Fuck you for laughing at it with your buds. Fuck you for promoting a rape culture that you're a victim of. Joseph Kahn for giving you a pity roll and hundreds of bucks after you got rejected for the role of Adam because you weren't funny enough. Fuck your character embodied. You wouldn't engage to a thing. How can you propose? For 2 years you stayed away from the ring. Fuck you for not leading as an example. Fuck you for not giving a shot to those trapped in your shadow. You're from Philly, so fuck you for the last two Cassidy battles.
Okay, you get points for that. You gonna get points for that.
Fuck you! He's
starting to character assassinate. Look how long he's waiting. He's in the end of the third, and he's talking to him about bodied and being a victim of a rape culture. Like, battle's over.
Fuck you for thinking King of the Dot isn't the place for you. Fuck you for only showing up to a smack event. Mean? Look what you made me do. And fuck the URL for last night when they hacked our pay-per-view. I mean, you got...
Bro, Sharon is
something else, bro.
Didn't happen, but okay.
Keep going. I mean, people want to go against Rome, but watch how I rhyme first. He wants to do this, he's digging up dirt, but watch how he goes in his guy's hearse. He says, I hate Spanish people.
Fuck you!
No.
Fuck battle rap! Fuck all of you, man! What you mean? You supposed to... I rapped an hour of material and I made sure every bar was fucking, like, if I fucked something up in there, it's because I was rapping for so long. These guys are rapping for 2-3 minutes, and what is he saying right there? What did he just say, bro? Repeat that.
People want to go
Fuck
against
you.
Rome, but watch how I rhyme first. He wants to do this, he's digging up dirt, but watch how he goes in his guy's hearse.
He wants to dig up dirt, but watch how he goes in this guy's hearse.
Okay, so...
Well, what the fuck? Like,
in
he's trying
Canada,
to...
In Canada, they say guy instead of me.
I know what the fuck... He's
so
just
he's saying,
worded,
watch how
just,
you go in my hearse like I'm gonna
just,
kill you.
It's just, again...
Lyrically.
Like, I know
my
what,
words.
I know what he's saying.
Watch
it's just, again, like, they got too short of rounds to
kidding.
Be doing this.
I'm just trying.
They got 2-3-minute rounds. It should be flawless. Like,
yeah.
What are you saying right there? You ain't rapping for half an hour.
You ain't rapping for half an hour.
Fuck out of here. You can't rap for that long.
Watch how I rhyme first. He wants to do this. He's digging up dirt. But watch how he goes in his guy's hearse. He says, I hate Spanish people. I mean, is that how your mind works? He also said, organic, watch me fuck a bitch. I'll show him how that dime hurts. You're right. He was watching what happened.
That's not that bad. How the dime hurts, man. What is he gonna rhyme it with? We'll guess that though. Alright, let's watch the rest of this. Let's get through it, Diz. We gotta.
Organic, watch me fuck a bitch. I'll show him how that dime hurts. You're right. He was watching while I had a tag team with my verse. See, I fucked
him. Two verse in there. Poor my verse.
Dragged my verse like she was about to come out like to like the biggest and she's like, yeah, oh shit.
Yeah, you're
just, I'm in a tag team with Charrón.
Yeah, you're just
Hey! Facts. That was a light open. You're an ungrateful hypocrite. The truth's got a sting. I'm more successful than you, and I'm still doing my thing. So, Trevor, it's time to see you in the ring. It's
Yo, Jason. Thank you, man. Appreciate you.
Successful than you, and I'm still doing my thing. So, Trevor, it's time to see you in the ring. It's Charrony, baby, to prince and soon to be king. Let's get it.
Let's go.
Aww. Luke, thank you, man. Disaster, you should go in on this dude. I want to see you, son Charrone. Well, if you haven't been watching this whole
Why?
Fucking
so everybody
watch.
Everybody could say this battle is fucking, the battle would be weak as fuck. I have no interest in it, bro. He just got toppled.
Anyways, so he did okay. He did good enough to be there for Roan's clearly well thought out return. This event should have been SoulCon versus Charrone and Disaster versus Roan. This is another situation where you couldn't have known that.
Wait, who did you want Charrone to battle?
Charrone should have battled SoulCon. And I should have battled Roane. Like, this is what happened at this
Imagine,
event. Like, I'm just saying,
weird.
Like, that
SoulCon's return and he battles Charrone.
But that's, we would have never known that. Obviously, Charrone wouldn't ever
there's
get
like,
a
no,
name like
no,
SoulCon.
Not saying,
but now he could, because look
just
how
no
fucked
backstory.
Up he is.
There's
now he's on Charrone's level. Like, if they're going to set it up, they can set it up. But, like, before, SoulCon still had his extreme top-tier status. Now he has to start from the ground up, you know what I'm saying? He can't call out.
Charrone's not at the ground, though.
No, I'm just saying, like, he can't call out. Like, now he can't battle, like, he's not going to be able to battle Serve for any of the people he
SoulCon?
Wanted to battle. Yeah, he's not going to get those battles. The people that he wanted, he's not going to get those battles.
Yeah.
Even Pat's not going to battle him. Bro, Thesaurus won't battle. Nobody will battle him. Like, you got to know.
SoulCon, I'll battle you.
SoulCon!
He's like Avocado.
Hey, but listen, I'm not going to battle Soul again. But listen, the point is, the way Roan thought out his return is what should have happened with what's his name? You know what I'm saying?
Charrone.
With SoulCon. Yeah, because here's the thing. Charrone is battling constantly. So he's using that against him. Like, I've been here and I'm battling every day and I'm killing shit. And you left. So, like, Roan being able to come back and do that to him should not have been possible because it was a real body bag. Like, it's 3-0. It's a 3-0. It is, bro. I'm sorry. Like, you know what I'm saying? It's hard
this
for me
battle?
To... battle? Yeah, it's a 3-0.
Man, we haven't even watched Roan's third.
What do you mean? It's
we
done.
We haven't watched Roan's third.
All right.
We have to watch Roan's third.
I remember Roan's third. I remember Roan's third.
I know, but we haven't watched it yet.
But there's no way...
Wink, wink, Diz.
Bro, there's no way... Listen, bro. There's no way this is going to hold up. Look what he just said, bro. He went off on all these things. Morgan piano recital.
Fire.
What is... bro,
kidding.
Nobody...
I'm kidding.
You have to understand.
It's incestual. I get it.
When we see the... Like, when the pay-per-view happened, the third was the least close fucking round.
Mm.
This was... If
you're
anything,
spoiling the movie, Diz. You spoiling.
I'm just saying. Look, I don't. All right, you're right.
Spoiling
I shouldn't have said
it.
That. I shouldn't have said that.
Okay.
But everybody knows we've seen the pay per view. I'm just saying it's been like a fucking 2 months. It might be a little different, but it's not going to be.
Okay. Well, let's get it. Bottom of the third on Rome.
Final round. It's on Rome. Round three. Let's go. King
look
of the
how dot. Worried Charrone is.
It's a great battle, man. Thanks
for loving.
It's a wrap.
Bro, I always knew he had a side hustle, popping fly shit in the bay. I always assumed he worked for Uber, because he always drives women away. But you love to talk about this money and never tell us where you got it. Turns out you were a door-to-door energy salesman who just ran all people's pockets. You were scamming their life away and then treating it like a game. And because of your lying ways, they were broke in their dying days. Well, try that shit with my grandma. Find out if she's really with the shit. She'd be off the porch. Yeah.
Yo, that's really... I didn't even catch that, but that's crazy. Segment.
Try that shit with my grandma. Find out if she's really with the shit. She'd be off the porch like Clint Eastwood. We'd see Billy pistol whipped. Bro, being part of a pyramid scheme makes you a sucker regardless. But scamming all people? I give a fuck if you're autistic. That shit is retarded. Bro, scamming the senile? Old folks losing their memory? The irony, you taking advantage of people who aren't all there mentally. Well, I bet you you wish you were back selling gas, facing the elderly instead of me, because I'll give you the option that you didn't. Let's see if you keep that same energy.
Damn. Damn.
I got slept on. That was crazy.
Because, man, not everybody knows the shit. Whether they got a backstory to the shit or not, that shit is fucking ridiculous. You know what? He's really about the tightest. Yeah, oh, sorry, my bad. Yeah, yeah. This is a crazy fucking round.
Yo, I'll get your girlfriend's dog when she comes through the East Bay. Then I'll pay Michael Vick to abuse it each day. I'll bring it right up in the room. If she refused the BJ, then I'll beat it right in front of her like Louis C.K. Bro.
If she refused the BJ?
This is Roan.
Are you going to refuse the BJ?
Yeah, Roan, you're letting us down here, man. We were, like, seriously, like, on a roll here, and you just kind of just threw a monkey wrench.
How'd
there.
The date go last night? Oh, good, but she refused the BJ.
So I just beat it in front of her, you know? Louis C.K.
You know what? That doesn't mean nothing, Roan. You shouldn't have said that.
Yeah. Hilarious.
You wasted a bar. No, that was a good bar, though. It still is funny. Yeah. It is.
Still made me laugh.
See, it could get real eventful if I use a still against you. You catch six from the trade. That's a Philly special. Our Philly pretzel Billy pistols. He'll be looking like Whoopi's braids. But if I really pistol Billy pistols, he'll be looking like Billy Mays. Oh, that. Wow. So you're saying that autism shit's real, though? Ooh, that's mean. I bet you wish you listened to Hollow and skipped the flu vaccine. Bro. You told him.
See, people would have to know Hollow tweeted that shit.
Hollow, I told him.
People would have to know Hollow tweeted that shit. That's so funny.
You told him.
What a weird observation.
But I love my people. I love my people with autism unconditionally. Best believe it. But for you to bring it up in a title match for sympathy and expect other people not to talk about it, almost seems like you're asking for special treatment. See, I'm here to dig
that
a hole for
fire.
You. So remove and lower you. Just because you have autism doesn't mean I'll take it slow for you. I'll whip your ass like anyone else, because that's what I'm supposed to do. But it's a shame you don't understand social cues, because you have no idea how bad I'm owning you. I mean.
Okay, so hold on.
Crazy.
First of all, before he even got to, he rhymed slow for you with social cues and don't know how bad I'm owning you. But before he got to that, he tied in a situation where Charrón really was asking for special treatment.
Where?
That's it? You're not going to laugh?
No, I didn't hear what you said.
I'm saying the bar, it's so good because the average person will just be like, oh, I bet you probably want special treatment. But, like, Roan went and tied it into a situation. He was like, I don't know, you know, asking her again.
Yeah.
And you kind of, it's just so, I don't think people realize how good that is. Even the crowd was still
Roan's
sleeping.
Roan's super charismatic, too. He performs it so good.
Yeah, the way his eyes popped out. Look, watching
him. Yeah, his performance
his
is crazy.
His eyes pop out when he says,
I mean, I read up on nonverbal learning disorder as some insight on your brain for me. It said you could read a Civil War book, remember every general's name, but not realize it's about slavery. And that explained to me.
Do you realize how devastating what he's saying is and what he's about to say, pretty much? Do you understand?
You paused it before the punchline.
But listen. Where already he's going with this
good.
Is.
It's good.
He's doing a parallel universe thing. What concept, when have you ever heard a concept said to Charrón like this? So you're looking at a person right now who, at this point in the round, has opened up a wormhole. Has opened up a wormhole, all right?
Yeah.
Of original content, which is going to be followed, most probably, by all original content. Keep in mind, we're only praising people for their hard work and their good work. This is fucking excellent already, bro.
General's name, but not realize it's about slavery. And that explained to me why your concepts can't hit and each angle's a bad miss, because other than General Lee, you really don't understand shit.
Unbelievable.
I kept reading. I kept reading. And I almost felt bad for the geek. But the deeper I got, what did I happen to see? It helps you focus on a task, You are the man with your freeze. It helps you access rhymes. You are fast on your feet. You're less likely to be insulted. That helps you battle with ease. It compartmentalizes thoughts, all your facts and your schemes. So by the time I finished reading, I was mad as can be until I realized the one that's really disadvantaged is me.
Are we ready to listen to that? Are we ready to talk about that?
Yeah.
Why, here's the thing, and it's very easy to understand. What we were critiquing Charron for over here is the same thing that Roan is doing really good. He's telling him you're the man with the freeze. He's making his point, like, you know what I'm saying? He's saying you're fast on your feet. He's telling him all these things without using panic increased, and you understand? And happens to rhyme with it. It's the same fucking scheme.
Yeah, that's crazy.
This couldn't have happened at a better way for me to explain to you.
Yeah.
That Charron only had to rhyme four of them. All right?
Yeah.
And he couldn't even get four of them off. And Roan just strung together. We're going to count them. Go back. We're going to count every single one of them.
And that explained to me why your concepts can't hit and each angle's a bad miss, because other than generally, you really don't understand shit. I kept reading, and I almost felt bad for the geek.
Okay.
But the deeper I got, what did I happen to see? It helps you focus on a task. You are the man with your freeze. It helps you access rhymes. You are fast on your feet. You're less likely to be insulted. That helps you battle with ease. It compartmentalizes thoughts, all your facts and your schemes. So by the time I finished reading, I was mad as can be until I realized the one that's really disadvantaged is me.
I think I was like 10 or 11. I just lost count. So the only part in there was battle with ease.
Yeah, that was...
That was the only one.
It was just tossed in there, for sure.
You know what I'm saying? But, like, that was the only part where he strayed away from the whole Fresh Coast model of just every multi has to match.
Mm-hmm.
But it's still an extremely impressive put-together pattern with getting his point across in a personal without adding a bunch of random shit. You know what I mean?
Yeah, for sure.
I mean, do you know how hard it is to be a battle rapper without autism?
Insane humor. Top-notch humor. This battle's already... The third round is done already.
To be a battle rapper?
Yeah, the Charron. He ready.
Without autism? Who's done a drug, a beer? Who's really got bitches? I started scheming. Vaccining. You don't know how bad I want this shit. The more I'm reading, I can't believe it. It's like everybody's got the shit. Fucking Steve Jobs, Dickinson, Einstein, Newton, Bill Gates, Burton, Mozart, Darwin. And wouldn't it be crazy if someone like Jobs went on stage with a sob story instead of making the iPod? If Einstein was woe is me instead of finding relativity? If Newton never understood his own gifts, gravity? If Mozart never played strings and curled up in a ball? If Darwin had played the victim and had never evolved? See, that's the problem. That's the problem. That's my problem.
And that is extremely original.
Yeah.
I told you he was going to open a wormhole of original content, and he did. He followed all of it up by insane shit. Like, even the humor in, what did he just say, like, about the autism? He said...
The humor?
No, he had, like, a really, like, humorous line right now. He said... forgot what it was, but it was right before he went into the
Bill Gates. How hard it is to battle not with...
Yeah, that's what it was. Like, you know how hard it is to battle without it? That is extremely original.
Yeah, it is.
Nobody said some shit like that. So then he named all the people that I didn't realize most of them had a form of autism. I didn't realize Bill Gates or... I think I heard Steve Jobs, yeah. But I didn't know all that. So, like, that's informative, too. And then he put it into a very... very original way, like, to again what I called Charron out from in the beginning, using it as his own clutch. This is why good angles are important, because if you don't use good angles on people, somebody will reformat your shit and fuck you up.
Mm-hmm.
This is how he's doing it. He's basically taking Charron's strong point that he uses, and he's completely
And now Charron has no way to respond to this because it's the last round.
Yeah, for real. He can't rebuttal anything.
No. That's...
He couldn't even if he did.
That's
though.
My problem with to... your scamming shit. It isn't moralism. It doesn't matter how rich you are if you're still making poor decisions. You're a scumbag from your actions. No one's exploiting you. Being autistic doesn't make you any less of a man, dog, but your choices do. See, I'm upfront. You're sidewinding. I'm a lone wolf. You're hive-minded. I'm obsessed with originality. You're the most derivative on the battle scene. You have the charm of Rush Limbaugh. Women love me. You make their skin crawl. I'm good at everything. You find your second talent, then show me. You're a punk bitch, fuck stick, one-trick pony. And those that pay attention are never gonna respect them. It has nothing to do with autism. We're just on different ends of the spectrum. And he could never match my moves, either in or out the ring. They call me Rony Babe the Prince, but to you, I'll always be the king. Let's go.
That was the least close round. So back to my original, so my overall conclusion of this is that Charron didn't realize the weight of Rone's return and how serious he took it. Clearly he thought Rone was coming there to have a head ice battle. He thought he was going to see that Rone.
And Rone took it extremely serious.
To where Charron couldn't predict where he was going to go with his shit, because he would have had responses from it weaved into his shit. He wouldn't have had to rebuttal, because what he said would have been the answer, kind of like what I did to Danny. Everything Danny like said to me, I already had the answer and all my shit. So it's that type of shit. Like, if you waste time in a small battle, that's why I don't like those, like, little battles. I call them little battles, like 3-minute rounds, like, I don't know, 2-3-minute rounds. Like, it's just, maybe they went longer. I think they went a little longer, but
yeah, I mean, it's 42 minutes.
It seems like they wrapped like 4 or 5 minute rounds. Yeah. It seemed like Rone had like a 5-minute round. I'm not sure.
Yeah, it seems like he wrote more than Charron, honestly.
The thing is, but I'm gonna say, I'm not being negative. The thing is about these smaller battles, I'm not like looking down on them, but I'm saying, like, you don't got time to really waste talking about anything. And I like what Charron and Rone do, but not in this format. I can't give them, they're wasting time. Like, if they're wasting time on the line when you only have this much to get it off, the other person's gaining momentum on you. Don't have a big battle to judge them as to where you let some shit slip you. It's like you're counting the seconds damn near. It's every single scheme together. So if you have like 7 parts that hit and the other guy only has 4, and you look at that, when you compare it to somebody, you can immediately see somebody that's more consistent that way. Rone wasted less time. Did most of it in his first round.
Yeah.
He started off slow with like...
I think his first and his third were the most powerful.
What was his first? His first and his third?
Yeah.
Maybe, you might be right. I forgot which one's the first. I didn't write on it. But, I just, you know, when I look at a battle, especially nowadays, because it always changes. Back in the day, like, you know, there was the dumbfounded era and the SMP and all that shit and being funny, and there's different shit, people doing gun shit all the time. I think right now where it's shifting is, like, people want to hear, like, extremely, like, personality crushing shit and shit that really effectively gets the point across to the fans to where they're like, yes, I know, yeah, I agree, I wanted to say that. Mm-hmm. I think it's more of that. And if you're someone like Charron and you're like, oh, I'm just gonna talk about how he turned his back on everyone, when nobody's ever said that, you know what I'm saying, it's a thought that was just in his head. Yeah, only Charron had
a pain of narrative.
And when you do that, you gotta be careful as a battler, because you could either go with everybody is saying, this is why it's dangerous, you could go with what everybody is saying, because what everybody's saying is different from what they're thinking. You could go with what they're saying, but the battler is gonna be prepared for that.
Mm.
You gotta know what they're thinking. That's the whole part of being talented at this. You gotta know what they're thinking, but also bring up shit that they're not aware of. And also, Rone exposed things about Charron that people didn't know necessarily, or did, but it wasn't predominant.
Yeah.
About like his actual personal life, about his working and his job, about the thing with organic. Then he has a bunch of other shit that I'm not gonna say is 100% true. But like he brought up more things about Charron than Charron was able to bring up about Rone. He, you said in this one battle, this, like, that was a lot of his shit. When he started off with the racist rebuttal round, it was always just bringing up what he has said before. You said this against Head Ice. Like, you know what I mean? Instead of just actually... So Rone was really ruthless. And you could tell that Charron kind of irritated him, probably asking for the battle. So you could see some of it in the battle.
Yeah.
You could see Rone coming there like... fuck off type of shit. Yeah. He had the whole vibe about him like, bro, you've been annoying the shit out of me and I'm going to snap your neck now. Rather than them just having separate lives, Charron calling Organic and being like, hey man, you think we can set up something with Rone? And then Organic hitting up Rone and be like, hey, we want to set you up for battle. And then they come and they show up. It would have been a different Rone. But this is a Rone that Charron has been poking at. And telling him, I beat you freestyle once. And, you know, like, he's doing all that shit. Which he did, you know what I'm saying? I think, I'm pretty sure I remember.
Yeah, it was. Yeah.
Charron fucked Charron him won, up, right? Yeah. So Charron won that. So, you know, it's his bragging rights to bring that up, too. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I brought it up to the dumbfounded when we said, like, it was part of the thing, like, where I was like, I already beat you in a freestyle battle. Like, so, all in all, I hope Rone could constantly bring this level. Maybe people need to piss Rone off or something. Like, he needs to, because this is a different...
I think Rone just needs to be motivated, really.
Motivated. Because yeah. This is a different Rone than the Rone versus Head Ice.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Like, leagues. For like, sure. Like, I don't know. The time off made him better. Does time off necessarily make you rustier if someone like Rone could have a Head Ice performance and come back and have a Charron performance?
Yeah, it's crazy.
Those are opposite ends of the spectrum things. Yeah. Speaking of that bar, which was also incredible. In that third round, Rone had a lot of fucking shit like that where he went into personal shit, then opened up a personal world. So he was already in the personal realm. He's personally dissing him. And then he was doing multis inside of it and metaphors about it. So this is why it became really crazy, is when he opened that door, he just wouldn't stop. Like, about the autism shit, like, and he did it in a very talented way. First, he put himself at a disadvantage, started saying, like, oh, look, it reminds me when I battled Manas. Manas is blind. I made up a whole scheme about how he's better than everybody, about with smelling, hearing, and everything else. I'm not saying he's seen that battle or did that, not at all. It's mm-hmm. a completely different thing. Yeah. But it's a similar concept where you've taken somebody's flaws, you're magnifying them, and you're making them better than your best qualities.
Yeah.
You know, and I thought that was incredible. And then he didn't stop. He did this special treatment shit. Also tied into an actual personal. You gotta dissect the shit for what it is. It's not just a punchline. Sometimes people do that. They'll just say the punchline, but it has no background context to it, which makes it that much more devastating. Which is why I gave props to Charron with his rebuttal saying he has retarded stacks. Because mm-hmm. he's allowed to say that. It's almost like Geechee saying like some gangbang shit.
Yeah.
And you wouldn't talk to him like how you talk to DNA. Like, shut the fuck up, you fucking gummy worm. Like, you ain't gonna fucking pull out shit. An idiot. Break your wrist with a cap gun, faggot. So, like, that's the type of shit that I'm talking about. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I come out of nowhere with my jabs. I'm, like, having a bit. So, you know, let's stick to the analysis. Well, I mean, how do you see the rounds? Let's ask you, and then I'll gather my thoughts a little bit more. And just, I mean, how do you see? Because I feel like you have it 3-0 also, but you might give Charron a round.
I think the second is debatable, but I give Rone the second. So I think it's 3-0.
But Rone, a little close.
No body. I don't think it's a body by any means.
It's hard to say if it's a body. I was just saying that. It's hard to say if it's a body, but it's a clear 3-0. I feel like Charrón's best shit was just not enough to chip away at the overall message that RONE had.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, he might have did really good in one round, but whatever round that happened, the second, right?
Yeah.
It wasn't good enough to chip away at the reinforcements that were in the beginning and the end. It, as a cohesive story, his hits did minimum damage. At the time, they might have seemed like that, but once the battle finishes and you see what RONE was leading up to, that's how you could judge it like that and say it's a 3-0. But to judge it round by round, I completely understand what you're saying.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just saying at an overall message, how did you throw off the message that RONE was bringing? Especially being a freestyler, you're supposed to do that.
Yeah.
You're supposed to throw that. That's what I did to Danny the whole battle. Like, I'm throwing off his message constantly. Like, and I'm answering him with shit I didn't fucking have in my shit intended to spit. So, and it's premeditating and having those answers, because being a really good freestyler is being able to predict what somebody's going to say to you. And I know Charrón's really good at that. He knows what people are going to say. So he should have had mad answers for shit that would have seemed like freestyles or whatever.
Yeah,
like, just like, premeditated,
oh,
like, perfect. Yeah. He didn't have enough of that. Maybe because Charrón went first. Also, I seen here that he got some of his powers taken away, which are the usual answering back everything you say.
Yeah.
So now if Charrón went second, we kind of would have been seeing a more 100% Charrón that's actually like... But his freestyles weren't even hitting like that.
Yeah, he didn't have a lot of...
He didn't have an epic freestyle moment.
Yeah.
He usually does.
And he usually does, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? He usually has a freestyle bar that's like, all right, that was crazy as fuck. He didn't do that in this battle. Either RONE just had him fucking pressed with his whole storyline and Charrón couldn't chip at it. And that's another thing that you have to take in. You have to factor that in. Like, Charrón could flip anything. Why wasn't he able to pick apart RONE's story like that? The answers back to some of the shit was very vague and general, again, what RONE was saying to him, which always ties back into RONE was saying to him. That's why it's hard to give Charrón any round clearly. Like, because almost anywhere you go in the battle, you'll find a contradiction and an answer from RONE.
Yeah,
that's true.
That's very true.
To end that out, I'm pretty sure RONE is going to be back to do more shit. And that was an incredible performance. I haven't enjoyed three rounds together like that in a minute. I don't know what was the last three rounds I really enjoyed like that. A lot of Geechee and Rum shit and all of Pat shit. But
surfing Geechee.
But like, for real, that was crazy from Ro, man. Everybody definitely got to give him his props so he knows how much he's appreciated, so he could have another one of those fucking... And just
I agree.
Back.
Roan is the fucking shit.
And not the shit on
shout
Charrón,
out,
too.
Shout out both Charrón and Roan.
Yeah, yeah. Shouts out to Charrón, man. Hey, you know, we just giving you hard criticism because
you
talk a lot of
for.
Shit.
This is what the show
well,
is
that's
for.
What I do on the show. You got a lot thinking. Of dick suckers on here. I'm not going to suck dick. I'm going to tell you guys how it is. I don't give a fuck if you're my friend. If I come here, if me and you are friends, be worried if I come on here and
well,
watch
what's wrong
shit.
With dick suckers, Diz?
I'm just saying, dick riders, cheerleaders, sorry, but let's be PC, meh. Pom-pom holders, don't even call them cheerleaders. That's disrespectful to their kind. But yeah, just all in all, just, you know what I mean, word of mother. That's definitely how I want to end this out. I want to say word of mother and...
Let's go. Disaster, everybody. I'm so happy to do this with Diz today. It was a fucking lot of fun. He's like the best of this shit, and I was glad to watch that battle with him. So, yeah.
Well, you know, I'm going to give you the honest opinion. You know what I mean? RONE did not have a lot of mistakes. If we give a RONE overall score, like a scorecard thing, I'd go for like a 94%. That's how high. Like, he had like a 6% margin of error in there.
Yeah.
Charrón, probably like, I hate how I mistake their names. You guys are idiots for that. One of you better change your name or something. I'd put Charrón, because I want to be generous to him, so I'm just going to put him at a 70%. I'm not trying to, but he, that's being really nice, bro. Like, there's people that are going to see your shit and just be like, fuck this whole shit. So I'm telling you. You know,
you get a 70% with Rone coming in with a solid 94%. Probably just a couple hit and misses. That was it. Like, that you could count throughout the whole battle.
You know what I mean?
Word up. All right, guys. Thank you guys for watching. Shout out Diz for coming by. Always a pleasure. He'll be in here soon again. Should we,
Shall we, yeah?
Yeah, if you want to. Totally down for it.
So...
I'll announce it because you're all low energy.
No, right now. I mean, no, yeah, you know, I'm tired as fuck right
okay,
now.
Okay, we have a new show coming up on Ruin Your Day.
Just don't give too much. That's it. That's all you got to know.
Just that?
I'm going to be doing things on the show.
Okay.
Tell them what type of shit I'm going to do on the show.
Don't say
I'm
going to
have a show. Right,
tell
I'm everything. Doing my own shit.
Diz is going to have his own show on Ruin Your Day. We're starting that up very soon. He has full creative control, and he can do whatever he wants on the show.
I'm going to destroy everybody.
So get ready for that. He'll have his own show right here on Ruin Your Day. I'm really fucking excited about it. And yeah, guys, stay tuned for more details and developments. You know what it is. Ruin Your Day, Disaster. Thank you guys. Have a good Thursday. Peace out.